Beautiful late afternoon in Jacksonville and a sellout crowd for two AFC Central Division rivals, the Baltimore Ravens and Jacksonville Jaguars, and plenty of aerial fireworks expected today. These are the two most prolific passing teams in the NFL. Jacksonville leads the league and Baltimore in second place. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Jacksonville. Tom Hammond, Bob Trumpy, seat belts fastened, seat backs in upright position, and ready for today's aerial show. Vinny Testaverde, of course, the second in the NFL in passing yards. He really has thrived in this no-huddle offense.
Yeah, Vinny Testaverde is the name. I think people around the NFL are wondering, what are they doing in Baltimore to get Vinny to do so well? 15 touchdown passes in the last five games. And Tom, when we talked to him, Mark Jabroda and Don Strock, the offensive coordinator, they all talked about how Vinny just loves to be in control of the offense, smile all over his face, and he's performing well.
Well, Jacksonville's Mark Brunell has performed just a little bit better. He leads the league in passing yards, so we know he can throw the ball, but he's a running threat too.
Especially last year against the Browns and the Jacksonville Jaguars, two wins against the Browns, he just killed them on the ground. That one touchdown he scored, plus he converted a couple of long third downs. But this kid got hurt in early October, had a bruised knee. And he's known for his running, but it made him a stationary quarterback, and actually it's made him a better quarterback. And this kid can throw. He is a threat to do both today.
Although Baltimore hopes all the action won't be in the air, they hope for some ground support from Bam Morris, gets his first start for Baltimore today. Ravens and the Jaguars kick off after we go back to Greg Gumbel in New York.
All right, thank you, Tom. Let's quickly get you caught up on the scores of the early games now. We'll begin with the game in Philadelphia, where the Eagles have fallen to the Buffalo Bills 24-17. There's Ty Detmer coming in today's game, unbeaten as the Eagles starter. 10-7 Philly, second quarter. Thurman Thomas caps a 16-play drive with a 5-yard touchdown, his seventh of the year, 14-10 Bills. And 17-10, the K-Gun operating on all cylinders. Jim Kelly to Quinn Early, 5 yards. It ends a 7-game touchdown drought for the Bills' big free agent acquisition. The Bills come away with a big victory in Philly today, 24-17, both these teams 7-3. In Kansas City, the Packers running into a Chiefs juggernaut today, 27-13, Chiefs in the lead there. At the Meadowlands, the New York Jets led early, or rather in Miami, rather, the Dolphins have beaten the Colts by a score of 37-13. In the Meadowlands now, the New York Jets fall to the Patriots, 31-27. Rich Kotite looking on. The Jets blew that 3-touchdown lead under 5 minutes left in the game. Bledsoe, his third touchdown pass of the day. This one to Keith Byers for 2 yards. It gave the Patriots the lead that they would hold on to. They win it by a score of 31-27. In Cincinnati, the Bengals have taken the lead over the Pittsburgh Steelers, 31-24. Still about 5 and change to play. In Washington, the Redskins with a 34-27 lead over Arizona. In New Orleans, Houston handing the Saints a lunch today, 31-14, the final there. In Tampa, the Raiders and the Bucks have gone to overtime. Cole Ford missed a 28-yard field goal in the final seconds. And St. Louis, big time over the Falcons today, 59-16. We'll send you to the kickoff in Jacksonville right after this.
In 1908, one of the favorites in the great New York to Paris race was a motor car built by Siemens. That was then. This is now. Today, Siemens builds over 700 automotive products, from fuel injectors and microprocessors to halogen headlights. Siemens, creating technologies to keep America and the world moving in the right direction. Siemens, precision thinking.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Very simple. No stress. They arrange to pick me up free, so I don't have to ask anyone for a ride. See? No stress.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Hey, you're a guy, and guys need protection made just for them, like SpeedStick. Our new pack is easier to handle and has a new comfort top. It's a better way to get that same great SpeedStick protection, just for the guys.
Welcome back to Jacksonville, the St. John's River, just outside the stadium here in Jacksonville on a cool afternoon, 64 degrees at kickoff, and as the sun goes down, it's going to be downright chilly by Florida standards with a wind 12 to 15 miles an hour. Ted Marchabrota in his, of course, first year as the Ravens coach, this new team, which was the Cleveland Browns, but in his 28th season as an NFL head coach. And Tom Coughlin, the original coach of the Jacksonville Jaguars, team's second year.
year of existence. Coughlin hired actually a year early, made the rounds checking out all the various minds in the NFL to find out what you do with an expansion team, and is building this one from the ground up. And getting set to kick off, Hollis of the Jaguars, as the Ravens have won the toss and elected to receive with Lewis and Baldwin, the deep men, Lewis on the left, Baldwin on the right for the Ravens. Sellout crowd here in Jacksonville, the two teams with identical 3-6 records. The Jaguars coming off their bye week after losing to the Bengals, and of course the Ravens beaten by Cincinnati last week after leading, what, 21-3 at halftime?
Yes, that's right. And of course the Ravens coaching staff reminded us that this is the third time this season they've played a team after that team has come off its bye week.
Hollis set to kick off, and the game underway. Short kick taken by Baldwin. Andy Baldwin cutting back, and a nice return, just grazed, which made him lose his momentum a bit and taken down at about the 36-yard line by Jeff Cobb. Here the way the Ravens will start with Tony Jones. Jonathan Ogden, the rookie, is drawing raves from the Baltimore coaching staff. Williams, Blackshear, and Brown. Vinny Testaverde already with 20 touchdown passes, equaling a career high. Morris gets his first start at running back. There's a look at Bam Morris, who of course was suspended as part of the NFL's substance abuse program after pleading guilty to the marijuana possession charges, getting his first start as a Raven and getting the first call, pounding his way forward, stopped just short of the 40-yard line. Here's the way the Jaguars, with Smingy, Davey, Yurkovic, and Simmons, the veteran up front. Hardy, McManus, Robinson, Beasley, Washington, Hall, and Hudson. Hardy and Beasley getting starts as rookies. Beasley, of course, has taken over with the injury to Dave Thomas, who is out for the season at left cornerback.
First question answered. The Ravens go back to the huddle, probably to save their defense a little bit, be a little more deliberate. But they score, and score often from the no-huddle offense.
Second and long here with a blitz coming for the Jaguars. Testaverde slips and falls and immediately is covered by Kevin Hardy for a loss on the play.
When we talked to Ted Marchibroda and Don Strock, this is the dilemma that Baltimore has. You know, they've been so successful with the at the line of scrimmage offense. Vinny likes it a lot. But when you don't have a defense that you can put out on the field and trust, you've got to be very deliberate, very slow, protect the ball, and also use the clock. So their choice is to be deliberate here, at least to start.
Third and long, three wide receivers on. Nickel defense for the Jaguars. Blitz shown again. Ravens pick it up. Testaverde looking for help, now scrambling, still on his feet, made it only back to the 40-yard line before he's tackled by Tony Brackens, the rookie from Texas.
You can see Vinny did not want to run. Plenty of pressure coming here from the Jaguars. It's a fire zone, or zone blitz, as some teams call it. And you can see Vinny's got a lot of room to run here, but he just as soon throw it. And kind of gets caught in a wash and not enough for the third down conversion.
Greg Montgomery is on to punt for the Ravens, averaging 45.1 a punt. And Chris Hudson deep for the Jaguars. Whoops. Kind of a stutter step. Hudson lets it bounce, and it will be downed by the Ravens. There is a penalty flag back up field. Dorian Brew of the Ravens, the man that downed the ball, but will check the penalty marker.
Yeah, you can bet that that's a man went downfield a little prematurely there because of that hitch step by the punter. Yeah, there it is.
Jerry Mark Bright, today's referee. While they sort out the penalty, here's the way the Jaguars line up on offense. Boselli, of course, their top pick of a year ago. Coleman, Wydell. Tilski gets his first start, replacing the injured Brian DeMarco. And Searcy, the free agent acquisition at tackle. Brunell leads the league in passing yardage, but 13 touchdowns, 15 interceptions for him. Stewart, the leading ground gainer. And, of course, Risen and McCardell were teammates last year with the Cleveland Browns, the team that became the Baltimore Ravens.
Teammates. They combined for 103 catches, 1,410 yards, and 7 touchdowns for the Browns in 1995. Yeah, they were teammates.
Fourth down.
Penalty against the Ravens. Mark off 5 yards and make Montgomery punt again. And that smile you see comes from Andre Rison. Why? He's being paid by both teams today.
Yeah.
Can't lose.
Very unusual. Actually, he's being paid more by Jacksonville, but he's being paid by both teams today.
Montgomery again will punt. Low line drive kick. Hudson trying to chase it down, but can't. It goes out of bounds first. So Montgomery with a stutter step on his first try, causing a teammate to be downfield, and then a subpar punt when he finally did get it off legally. It only covered 41 yards. It did go out of bounds. So no return. Baltimore switched to the 3-4 defense about 3 weeks ago. They're really banged up. Some unfamiliar names in there. Lyle gets a start at left end to join Jones and Pleasant. Kroll, Lewis, the rookie. Caldwell, Goganius, a former Jaguar, their second leading tackler last year. Jenkins, Brady, Moore, and Turner. And, of course, their best cover man, Antonio Langham, at cornerback, not in there today. He is injured. First down for the Jaguars, their first snap. Brunell with a handoff and a reverse. It goes to Willie Jackson. And Jackson defended pretty well by the Ravens. Rick Lyle, who gets the start, smelled that one out and is tackling Jackson about the 27-yard line.
Yeah, some credit, too, to number 25 for the Ravens, Deron Jenkins. He's the corner, came up and really didn't allow the reverse man just a free move out there. Kind of helped. Interesting start. Run a reverse on the first play of the game.
A little trickery, but it netted only a couple of yards. Brunell with a short drop. His first pass.
Oops.
Hit the defender on the helmet. I believe Deron Jenkins, caught it on the helmet. Andre Rison never looked back for the ball.
Well, Brunell was on target. There is no question about that. Rison takes the outside release, and it looks to me like Brunell is expecting the inside release, but look, if you can hit somebody in the helmet, I mean, you've done your job. But right, Andre not looking back. Maybe he was blinded by the diamonds from somebody's watch like we saw yesterday, an $84,000 watch that presently would say 413.
Just like yours?
Not like mine.
From the shotgun on third and long, Brunell. Plenty of time. Zips it off the hands of Rison, intercepted. Intercepted on the carom by Eric Turner. And Turner picks off Brunell. That is the 16th interception this season. Eric Turner gets his third and the 20th of his career. Of course, the Ravens sporting two of the best safeties in the game.
You can't blame this on the quarterback. This is an accurate throw. Rison just has it rejected off his hands, and Rison's very good friend Eric Turner makes the pick.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Call 1-800-RENT-A-CAR. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up. By Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By FedEx, just what you want, just when you want it. With FedEx, it's the way the world works. And by the new Lexus ES300, the road is calling. Answer it.
Tom Hammond, Bob Trumpy in Jacksonville. Eric Turner just picking off a Jacksonville pass. Turnovers have been the downfall of the Jaguars this season. They now have a -8 turnover ratio. Pass complete to the tight end Brian Kinchin. He stopped at about the 35-yard line. That'll be nearly a 10-yard gain. Robert Massey stopping the tight end in his ninth season from LSU.
Tom, I do not want to go back to the Jacksonville offense, but certainly worth mentioning. That's the 8th interception that Mark Brunell has thrown in the now 3 games. He had 2 3 weeks ago, 5 2 weeks ago, and already 1 today. But that shouldn't count against Mark Brunell. That should be against Andre Rison.
Second down and about a foot. Morris has the first down, although not much more than that. Got a yard and then was thrown back, with Kevin Hardy leading the defensive charge for the Jaguars, their number 2 tackler on the season, the rookie from Illinois, second player taken in the draft.
And Bam Morris, this is just his 3rd season. Certainly been busy in those 3 years. I started with Pittsburgh, and then you mentioned the drug suspension. Lived with his mother outside of Dallas. Didn't want Didn't leave the house. Didn't want to answer all the questions.
Said for a month he didn't leave the house, and at times despaired of ever playing again, realized how much he missed the game. Here he is again, Bam Morris. Tough run, spinning his way close to the 30-yard line before Kevin Hardy makes yet another tackle.
And, you know, continuing on Bam Morris, Ted Marchabrota, wherever he's been as a head coach, he's always had a go-to running back, that one guy that can just give it to you. He had Lydell Mitchell in Baltimore the last time he was with the Colts. He had Thurman Thomas. He had Marshall Faulk. They wanted Garrison Hurst when he was released by Arizona. Cincinnati picked him up. He's very happy to have Bam Morris.
Saw the other scores late games today. Here in Jacksonville, no score. The Ravens driving after the turnover. Second down at the 30-yard line of Jacksonville. Testaverde had to spin Brian Kinchin around. Kinchin did make the catch, but then could not reach the first down marker. He'll be stopped just short, I think. Let's see the spot of the football. Well, it is enough. It is enough. He got a fairly generous spot and does have a first down.
It does appear like when you see Baltimore going back to the huddle, going to the line of scrimmage, that it's not really what they want to do. They've had so much success over the last 5 weeks just staying in the hurry up or at the line of scrimmage offense. This is a different mindset for Don Strock, the offensive coordinator, and the offense.
Of course, much controversy last week with the big lead over Cincinnati. Some thought they should have not gone to the no huddle, taken their time more. Up losing to the Bengals on a Pelfrey field goal in the last seconds. Morris carries again. Tom McManus, the middle linebacker, makes the stop. McManus from Boston College, where he played for Tom Coughlin. There he is.
Yeah, he doesn't complain about the way Coughlin coaches.
You know, he was used to it, huh?
Yeah. Tom Coughlin's got, he and Dom Capers, the two expansion coaches, there is no more difficult job in the NFL than trying to put together a football team. McManus knew what to expect, so he's not upset with Coughlin's approach as a head coach.
Interesting, several people with Boston College connections saying the current wagering scandal could never have happened with Coughlin as the coach. Delayed handoff, the draw play to Bam Morris, skipping inside the 20-yard line, tripped up there by Aaron Beasley.
Now, the one thing about Bam Morris is he's tried to keep himself in shape when he was out for the suspension. And he said even the coaches were wondering if he's in hitting shape and how long he can go. Pure adrenaline, your first start of the season, will take you through about a quarter and a half. But you wonder just how long Bam Morris can be Bam in his first start of the season.
Third and five. Testaverde setting up the screen pass, a tight end screen to Kinchin, and Kinchin has a first down. Stopped by Eddie Robinson and Kevin Hardy, the linebackers, who finally tracked him down. A tight end screen advances the ball close to the 10-yard line.
Well, we got a trend going here. Let's go with the underneath stuff. This is a very aggressive Jacksonville defense, although they run zone behind it. Good job out in front of blocking by Ogden, 75, but actually Kevin Hardy does a great job to make the tackle there, but not before they get the first down.
Kinchin already has three receptions in this first quarter. First down, the ball spotted just about the 12-yard line of the Jaguars. Bam Morris cuts up to the five and down there as he hit the defense head on. Aaron Beasley, the cornerback, got help from Kevin Hardy and finally got big Bam Morris to the ground.
Coming into the game, Bam had been averaging 5.7 yards a carry. Here's this nice cut. He just waits, hesitates behind the offensive lineman, number 69, Jeff Blackshear, and then fires up through that hole. That's the part you can't coach. You can't teach. So these kids either have it or they don't.
68% on the touchdowns for the Ravens in the red zone. Testaverde appears to be changing the play. Plenty of time. Now the coverage breaks down. Throws to the corner of the end zone. Michael Jackson. Yes, touchdown.
Whoa, wait a minute.
They said he was pushed out, that he would have come down inbounds in the end zone had he not been pushed out.
That's his ninth touchdown catch of the year.
Beautiful catch.
And 1 foot is down. Well, it's a good call.
Yep, I think so, too.
I don't think there is any question whatsoever that the contact by the corner, Mickey Washington, did not allow Jackson to get that second foot down.
I agree. I think it was a good call and a brilliant catch by Michael Jackson. As you said, 9 TDs. He came into the game third in rush and receiving yardage in the AFC. Extra point by Stover is good, and the Baltimore Ravens take advantage of Turner's interception to go up 7-0 on the Jaguars.
This is the NFL on NBC.
7-0 Baltimore, and a milestone for Vinny Testaverde. That's his 21st touchdown pass of the season. That is a career high. 21 TD passes in the 10th game of the season.
Well, he's just oozing with confidence, you know. He just thinks anytime he throws it down there, somebody's going to catch it for a score, and it's happening.
Matt Stover with a kickoff. And it hits the ground. Randy Jordan takes it on a hop. And Jordan is only to the 13-yard line, where he's tackled by Keith Goganius, the former Jaguar. Jacksonville's ball when we return.
Presenting the full-time four-wheel drive Lexus LX 450. It's everything a Lexus is, and everything a Lexus isn't.
In a side-by-side comparison,
we found that more people prefer the quicker, easier Energizer tester over any other on-battery tester. It's the best way to make sure your battery keeps going and going.
Good morning. This is your wake-up call. And this is the new Norelco Reflex Action Razor. A great shave with less irritation than blades.
Yesterday, it was just an idea, a notion, a whim. A few hours ago, it was a yearning, a dream. And then, as if by magic, overnight, it all came to be. Wishes crossed the sea, ideas took flight, and yearnings and cravings in all four corners of the earth were satisfied. It wasn't always this way, but with FedEx, it's the way the world works.
Richard Dean Anderson, Daphne Zuniga, Robert Loggia, Robert Guillaume, and Jane Leaves in the movie event of the season.
We are going down.
Pandora's Clock, NBC Tonight.
Next Saturday at 1:30 Eastern, Ron Paulus and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame host the upset-minded Panthers of Pitt. Notre Dame football is home on NBC.
6:05 left in the opening quarter. Baltimore up 7-0 after a 9-play, 45-yard drive after a turnover. An Eric Turner interception, and now the defensive front. Some odd-looking names and faces in that defense for the Ravens.
Yeah, they need a huddle just to introduce themselves again. Now, what's your name again? Who are you?
From the 13, Jacksonville with a first down. Play action fake. Brunell, Risen makes the catch, then is spun back by Donnie Brady. So Risen with his first catch after having one bounce off the helmet of a defender, failing to look back, and having the second bounce off his hands into the arms of Eric Turner.
So do you get the idea that maybe Andre Risen, with his bad situation in Cleveland, wants to make a point, you know, to the ownership of the Baltimore Ravens? He's the only guy they've thrown it at.
I told us yesterday, though, he was so happy he couldn't even say anything bad about Art Modell or the Ravens or the Browns. Getting paid by both teams, and happy here in Jacksonville, and finally healthy. James Stewart fights his way across the 20-yard line, tackled by Stevon Moore. It'll be third down.
Brought down by number 52, Ray Lewis and Stevon Moore.
Keenan McCardell and Andre Risen. McCardell with 55 receptions to lead the AFC. It's really blossomed here in Jacksonville.
Sure has. And Risen, of course, he went to minicamp with the Ravens, and then they cut him loose. And, yeah, he could not be happier down here, except he doesn't like the way Tom Coughlin coaches. So maybe wherever Andre goes, he's going to complain about something.
I think so. McCardell in motion, and from the shotgun, Mark Brunell. Scrambling now. Lowers. lowers his head and bangs to the 22-yard line. He'll be short of the first down. Tackled by Benny Thompson in the Ravens' nickel defense.
And, Tom, one of the things the Ravens want to do is assign a you're going to see Stevon Moore, and he's the spy on the quarterback. Brunell did such a great job of running last year. They do not want to play. Actually, it's Benny Thompson. Right. I got the wrong guy. But they want to keep somebody up there close to the line of scrimmage so that Brunell just can't rocket up the field. He is an outstanding runner of the football.
That is Benny Thompson, who made the tackle, who is injured.
Another defensive player for the Ravens injured. What did Eric Turner tell us? It wasn't an injury bug, it was an injury beast.
Now the plague continues for the Ravens. We'll take a break.
Liberty Mutual, helping people live safer, more secure lives, presents Playing It Safe. A 300-pound lineman meets a 200-pound safety at 10 miles per hour. Who's more likely to walk away unscathed? Stay tuned.
Hey, Randy, use an underarm motion.
Thanks, sir.
Owen Moore is an engineer in ergonomics at the Liberty Mutual Research Center. Owen figures ways folks can do their jobs better and safer. His team has saved the companies we insure millions.
Stan, vibrating devices can cause extremity numbness. Maybe there's another way.
Okay, Owen.
Safer, more secure lives.
Yeah, maybe not.
That's the freedom of liberty. Liberty Mutual.
When these two guys meet head on, you better believe it's going to hurt the safety more. But in the long run, the player who's in better shape is going to recover a lot more easily. That's why they train hard and eat their opponents for lunch.
Introducing McDonald's Deluxe Sandwiches. They're new. They're big. With fresh toppings and a bakery soft roll. The average adult has over 8,000 taste buds. Get ready to use them all. It's McDonald's with a grown-up taste.
Come closer. Closer. There. I'm the road. And I'm so bored. It's been so long since someone new has come into my life and hugged me. Caressed me, excited me.
The all-new ES300. The road is calling. Answer it.
Whew, what was that?
Welcome back to Jacksonville, where just a moment ago, Benny Thompson was able to get up and leave the field under his own power. And it's fourth down for Jacksonville. Brian Barker in punt formation for the Jaguars with Jermaine Lewis ready to accept the punt from Barker. Lewis dodged the first wave and crosses midfield down into Jaguar territory. Jermaine Lewis with a pretty good return for the Baltimore Ravens, who lead 7-0. Next Saturday, 5 p.m. Eastern, it's Hoop It Up. Watch as James Worthy leads the Laker Legends against the World Streetball Champs on the Court of Dreams, plus women's action featuring Olympian Lisa Leslie and more. That's Hoop It Up next Saturday here on NBC. Last punt covered 43 yards with a 17-yard return, and total yards in favor of the Ravens so far. They lead 7-0, and Eric Green makes an appearance in a two tight end formation here for the Ravens. First down from the 49 of Jacksonville. Play action fake. Testaverde throws it incomplete, intended for Bam Morris. The defense was all over him. Eddie Robinson had penetration and almost intercepted the ball. He arrived about the same time as the pass.
Excellent job by Jacksonville. The play action fake didn't fool anybody. And as you see, good pressure by Smengi, number 90, Brackens. And Vinny kind of throws it out there and hopes.
Some surprising results in the early games today with Cincinnati knocking off Pittsburgh 3-0 under Bruce Coslett. And Boomer Esiason, the former Bengal, has thrown a touchdown pass with 20 seconds left, sending Arizona and Washington into overtime. Bam Morris Good blocking up front. They pound out about 6 yards before the tackle is made by Don Davey.
Now, Tom, I got to tell you, this bunch right up here, this offensive line of the Ravens, they should be excellent run blockers. When you get a guy like Bam Morris behind him, not particularly quick, but a real sledgehammer of a running back, runs heavy, as coaches say, that's another aspect of this Baltimore offense that's going to bode well for them in the future. It threatens every defense if you can give it to Bam Morris and it can pick up 6 yards easily.
And speaking of heavy, these are two of the heaviest offensive lines in the NFL on display today. Third down, Bam Morris again. Nothing this time. Stacked up and thrown back at the line of scrimmage. Good defense by the Jaguars on that third and short yardage play.
Going to see number 28 just come flying in here. He is the safety who helps Dana Hall as the, that's an excellent hit by a safety on a 250-pound running back. Bracken's 90 helps, but newfound respect for number 28. He's a thumper.
Hall came flying to make the play, so Montgomery will punt for the second time. Chris Hudson. Fair catch called and made barely as he... Did a little double clutch and caught it again at about the 12-yard line. So Jacksonville will take over with 2:49 left in the first quarter and the Ravens up 7-0. A 31-yard punt by Montgomery.
So far, we've seen little offense out of Jacksonville. The offensive coordinator, Kevin Gilbride, with Brunell, Kevin said, look, when he hurt his knee, there went our problem solver because he couldn't run out of trouble. He couldn't turn a bad play into a good play. It's made him a better quarterback. He passes better, but on an expansion team, we need somebody who can get us out of trouble. Brunell was that guy until he got his knee hurt.
Jimmy Smith wide to the bottom of the screen, two wides to the top, a three wide receiver formation on first down. Now checking off. He's got it. Jimmy Smith runs under it and makes the reception in front of Donnie Brady of Baltimore. Brunell with a long strike to Jimmy Smith.
That was beautifully thrown. Jimmy Smith, originally drafted by Dallas, broke his leg in 93, had an emergency appendectomy in 94, released, signed by the Eagles, didn't play in 95. He comes down here, turns out to be a great surprise. He is big, he is fast, and he'll go after the ball. And when you're an expansion team, you're constantly looking at the waiver wire for guys just like Jimmy Smith.
That one covered 34 yards. Here's James Stewart with nowhere to go. Keith Goganius making the tackle with help from Mike Caldwell. And Stewart never got out of his tracks. Loss on the play.
And this is a major problem for Jacksonville. We mentioned the size of the offensive line for both these teams. This Jacksonville offensive line should be more authoritative. They should control the line of scrimmage better. They have not, and it's kind of surprised the coaching staff down here.
Speaking of surprise, another one brewing as the Seahawks have an early lead on the Vikings. Brunell's pass deflected, and he spikes it back out of harm's way. Mike Caldwell at the line of scrimmage knocked away the pass by Brunell, and with it hanging perilously in the air, he just spiked it back out of harm's way.
Yeah, smart play. This guy hasn't played a lot of professional football, but decent pressure here by the Ravens. The Jacksonville Jaguars have an empty backfield. You see a lot of quarterbacks catch it and they lose yardage. He just makes sure it's an incomplete pass. You don't lose any yards whatsoever, but it still brings up third and 12.
This is the 19th start of Brunell's pro career. 11 in a row, which is the longest string, needless to say. Brunell across the middle, wide open, catch made by Andre Rison. Or is it Jackson? Eric Turner makes the tackle.
Spread formation by Jacksonville. There is a running back there to help Brunell, but this is beautifully thrown. Jackson goes right down the middle. He's over the top of the linebacker, Caldwell. An excellent catch, big pickup.
First down, Jacksonville. The ball at the 18 of Baltimore. Here's the give to Stewart. Fumbled the ball. Now are they saying the ball's down?
James Stewart carries.
Caldwell made the hit, Tom. And it wasn't a real ferocious hit, but it looks like Donnie Brady is on the ball. Jerry Markbright is about to tell us whose ball it is. Watch the white hat in there.
It is Baltimore football. Second Jacksonville turnover, and turnovers continue to haunt Coughlin and his Jaguars.
Watch 56 of the Ravens. There's the hit.
It's out.
Yeah, and then 51, Kroll also strips it. And the ball is on the ground. Good call, officials. Well, after a big play like that, the big catch by Jackson. So already two turnovers for the Ravens.
First one, of course, was converted into a touchdown, the interception by Turner. This one perhaps saves a touchdown as the Jaguars were moving the football. 7-0 Baltimore, final seconds of the first quarter. Hand off to Bam Morris, breaks free for a moment, and Morris has about 11 yards, stopped at the 27-yard line by Dana Hall and Robert Massey.
Now, we said earlier that quarterbacks love the at-the-line-of-scrimmage offense. Offensive linemen love downhill runners. They get that momentum going. They get their shoulders lowered, and they become such a small target. You don't have to block the defensive lineman long. Big pickup.
Jeff Blackshear with a springing block for Morris that time. Again, it's Bam Morris, the workhorse. And after the play, Orlando Brown levels one of the Jaguars and draws some boos.
That was a pancake.
What was that?
That was a flying pancake.
Hardy made the tackle, and Ben Beasley got his clock cleaned by Brown on the final play of the quarter. That's the end of the first quarter in Jacksonville, with the Ravens up 7-0.
It can't be. I got to see. It is. The 365. Boss, give a look.
Oh, yes, it's IBM ThinkPad. Harum hot waters.
As bizony.
It could be no other. Feel the track point. Feast your eyes on the screen. Can we swing it, boss, huh?
Meglepően olcsó.
Yeah. That's my boss. What a guy, huh?
Enterprise, rent a car for my trip?
Looks expensive.
It's not expensive, Mom.
They pick us up?
Sounds expensive.
Pickup's free, Mom.
Well, if it's not expensive, why didn't I get a convertible?
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
You know, Stick'em is illegal.
Who uses Stick'em?
Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers.
Get it off there.
Only the Sears Auto Center is filled to capacity with these top brand tires. And right now, all Michelins are on sale, including the Michelin WeatherWise at our lowest price ever. Only at our garage, the Sears Auto Center.
How'd you do on the math test?
Oh,
what happened?
I tripped over this.
Where do you think it goes?
It's that way.
Well, let's follow it.
Can you confirm a signal loss?
Houston, we have a problem.
Roger. Must be a couple of gremlins down here.
It's not TV. It's HBO.
Start the second quarter with Baltimore leading Jacksonville 7-0. And whether you agree that he should be playing or not, there's no question that Bam Morris has put life into the Baltimore rushing game.
And you put a kid like this behind that big offensive line of Baltimore, they're going to do some damage. First quarter, they did a lot to Jacksonville's defense.
Second down and a yard from the Raven 37. Who else? Bam Morris breaking free once again and crossing the 45 to the 46-yard line. First down, Ravens. Jeff Lagerman finally got him down.
Well, again, this is his downhill running. They pull Jonathan Ogden, 75. He gets a good hit on 51 Hardy. Lagerman has got to catch him behind, from behind. I mean, you got a 6'1", 250-pound absolute ball-peen hammer. I wonder how long he'll stay fresh enough to keep carrying him.
60 yards for the Ravens to only 4 rushing for Jacksonville. Just starting the second quarter. Play action fake to Morris, and Testaverde rifles it complete on target to Eric Green. And Green takes it to the 35-yard line of the Jaguars, where Kevin Hardy, forced to cover the big man out of the backfield, finally makes the tackle.
Now look at here, Jacksonville this time comes with a 3-4 defense, trying to do something to it, at least slow down this offense. Green still getting over that knee surgery he had in May. He has deterioration in the femur of his leg, but doesn't play a lot of plays yet for the Ravens, but certainly the biggest tight end ever in captivity.
That was his out of captivity.
Or out of captivity, yes.
That was his 9th reception for the Ravens this season. Testaverde again changes the play. It's a pass, and it's complete to Jackson. Wrestled down immediately by Robert Massey, short of the first down by about 3 yards.
Vinny sees soft coverage by the corner right up here and takes advantage of it. There's nothing fancy about this. Jackson just runs the hitch, and he keeps trying to push Massey off as best he possibly can. Again, we see Vinny Testaverde now with a running game in complete control here. Knows what he's doing. Great worries for the defensive coordinator, Dick Geron, at Jacksonville.
Morris, first down to the 21-yard line. Bam Morris continues to pound away. Tony Brackens, the rookie from Texas, makes the tackle for the Jags.
And Tom, at the point of attack, Ravens offensive line shoving the Jaguars off the line of scrimmage. And this is a big bunch. You got Zeus over there, 77. I mean, this guy, he can blot out the sun.
6'7", and about 350, Orlando Brown. Testaverde, sack, ball loose, and the Jaguars have it. Joel Smenge knocked the ball loose from Testaverde, and John Yurkovich recovered it. So the Jaguars finally get a takeaway after giving it up twice.
And they try to double-team Smenge with 77 Brown and Bam Morris. Smenge gets between the two of them. Jacksonville ball.
The engineers at the Pontiac Grand Am design cars for people who get a kick out of driving, complete with a powertrain built to precise aerospace tolerances. And that's kept more Grand Ams tearing along even after 11 years than any car in its class. So buy a Grand Am for a good time. Have it around for a good long time. Grand Am. Built for kicks, built for keeps. Starting around 15-2.
Perfect for any game, Domino's has the perfect play. Choose from 3 delicious crusts. There's classic hand-tossed, crunchy thin crust, or go deep with thick ultimate deep dish. So make the call and have it all. Call now, and you can enjoy a delicious Domino's pizza during the game. And why not add some of Domino's spicy buffalo wings or steaming hot breadsticks?
Silver Bullet. It's shipped cold to tap the clean taste of the Rockies.
Tap the Rockies!
The new Coors Light Wide Mouth can is here with a giant opening for a smoother pour.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Visa, the preferred card of the NFL. It's everywhere you want to be. By Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. By the U.S. Army, be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. And by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer, we are driving excitement.
Vinny Testaverde fumbling the ball under the hit from Smenge. Yurkovich recovers. Smenge made the play. Handoff to Natron Means, and the first carry for big Natron, who was promised more playing time this week after playing very well 2 weeks ago against Cincinnati, tackled by Stevon Moore.
And if you're wondering what's happened to Natron Means when he was released from San Diego, came down here, tore up his thumb. The ligaments were just destroyed, had surgery, and it's taken him this long to get back in shape. He goes in for one play and comes out.
Yeah, one and out for Natron, who picked up 5 yards on that first carry. Second and five for Jacksonville. I formation here. Mastin the fullback, Stewart the tailback. Fake to Stewart. Grinnell sacked back at the 20-yard line. Donnie Brady on a corner blitz. Mike Caldwell, the linebacker, converging on Brunell and taking him down.
Look where this blitz comes from, Tom. This is the corner who makes the sack. I mean, the Ravens are trying to take a big, are really taking a chance here. But Brunell has to set up, hesitate for just a moment. Brady gets there for the sack, so it's a good call.
Right call in the right time, wasn't it?
But that, he had to run like 20 yards to make that sack.
Brady, with his first sack, he's in his first season from Wisconsin, a free agent. From the shotgun, Brunell. Scrambling, firing, and complete. Catch made by Andre Risen. It'll be close to the first down. Let's see. It'll be very close, maybe just short. Deron Jenkins hit him. And now the Jaguars are arguing about the spot.
Good crisp move by Andre Risen. Does come back for the football. You know, more importantly on that particular completion, it tells me I don't think Mark Brunell is going to run today. He had a lot of room to run. See the way everybody just drifts out? Look at the hole right up there. And his choice is to throw the football. His knee must not still be completely healthy.
A yard short of the first down, so Brian Barker boots it away. Here's Jermaine Lewis. Flags are down. Lewis trying to get to the outside. Jermaine Lewis, only the kicker in front of him, and Barker makes a great play. There's Barker, who made the play, even got a pat from the opposing bench, although things got a little testy there for a moment. Remember now, there is a flag back upfield.
Yeah, but now wait a minute. Barker wants that piece of tape in his resume.
Well, yeah, what have you been saying about kickers?
They don't know what they're doing out there.
Barker saved a touchdown. Yeah. Looks like he's suffering the effects
right
at the
moment. He'll be in the training room tomorrow. He'll be treating something.
Holding on number 85, kicking team. Holding on number 43, receiving team. After possession was gained. The holding call on number 85 is declined by rule. The 10-yard penalty for holding is enforced from the dead ball spot. First down, Baltimore. Timeout.
Rashawn Adams of the Ravens and Rich Griffith of Jacksonville with the holds. Still 7-0. Barker made a great tackle.
You've been thinking about getting a digital satellite dish. And thinking. And thinking some more. Well, think about this. The people at Radio Shack can answer your questions. Plus, now they've got great deals. Own an RCA brand DSS dish with programming for about $1 a day plus installation. Up to 200 channels of select movies and sports available on USSB and DirecTV. Think about it. Better yet, stop thinking about it. Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
Today, more than ever, business isn't conducted in just one language, nor does it rely on a single currency or a universal set of rules. So what makes you think it operates at just one speed? That's why worldwide, UPS gives you more guaranteed on-time delivery choices than anyone else. After all, business today may know no boundaries, but when it comes to deadlines, it has plenty. UPS, moving at the speed of business.
Our race commemorates Sir Whitmore's ill-fated expedition to the North Pole. He was told he would have better grip with wide snowshoes, but he insisted on thin. He learned a hard lesson. Wider is better.
Introducing the new Wide Track Grand Prix. Its wheels are set wide for better grip to make tracks in any weather.
The spirit still calls.
The new Wide Track Grand Prix from Pontiac. Wider is better.
Tonight on an all-new Third Rock, Sally visits an all-male bar.
You look just like a real woman.
That's what I was going for.
And it's love at first sight.
Oh, yeah.
Just one problem. Sally's new boyfriend thinks she's a man.
Now slip out of that dress.
Oh. Plus, Lorraine Newman guest stars in an all-new Third Rock, followed by an all-new Boston Common NBC tonight.
Punter Brian Barker earned his stripes with this hit on Jermaine Lewis.
Actually, down here in Jacksonville, don't they want spots, not stripes? The team right. May let him in the team meeting room tomorrow after that hit, but he does go on and he puts his warm-up in. See, that's a kicker.
You sure he's not going home? He's got his warm-up. First down, Baltimore, 26-yard line. Testaverde changes the play. Play clock to two as he hands it to Morris. Hit in the backfield and dropped by Aaron Beasley. Beasley, the rookie from West Virginia, getting the start today, and good run support that time with a hit on Bam Morris.
Yeah, this is a blitz. You're going to see Beasley come right down the line here, and Jacksonville's got to do something to slow down this run game at Baltimore. Their choice is a corner blitz, and there's a certain amount of desperation in that attempt, and at the same time, it finally stopped them.
Testaverde, ball deflected, incomplete. Deflection by Jeff Loggeman of the Testaverde pass.
And Benny just kind of stood there and stared at the same spot. Loggeman couldn't get very much penetration, put his hand up as all defensive linemen are taught, knocked the ball away.
Ravens lead 7-0, but they're only 1 of 3 on third down conversions and facing a third and long here. Ernest Biner in the game. Biner can't handle it. Low pass from Testaverde and short of the first down anyway. And the Ravens will have to punt.
That time low and early. You're going to see the running back come out of the backfield, and actually Ernest Biner just never really gets his head around. The ball is almost there as he turns his head around, so finally the Jacksonville Jaguars are able to stop the Ravens here.
Greg Montgomery in punt formation. He's punted twice already in the game, averaging 33 a boot. At around the 33-yard line, Ricky Bell. Ricky Bell, number 42, is the man that came through to block at the rookie from North Carolina State.
Well, when you're 3-6, Tom, you got to try anything. Here's Bell right here. It looks like the upback really doesn't make a lot of contact with him. He gets by Stevon Moore, inside Stevon Moore, and he lays out in front of the punter, does it correctly. Big play by Jacksonville gives them great field position.
32-yard line of the Ravens. First down, 9:10 left till halftime, 7-0 Baltimore. Stewart, nothing in the running game, maybe a yard and a half, perhaps two. Mike Caldwell twisting down James Littleman Stewart in his second year from Tennessee, the number one rusher. Of course, from Morristown, Tennessee, grew up not far from Knoxville. Didn't even take any other recruiting visits, though he had his heart set on playing close to here in Gainesville for the Gators. His parents prevailed upon him to play closer to home so they could see him. Only the second first down for Jacksonville in this game. Second and 8 here. Cornell got it away. Flag is down. Natron Means made the catch for a short gain and then immediately hit by Lewis and Goganius.
Natron Means, tackled by Ray Lewis, penalty flag,
Penalty flag came flying into that pile around Brunel, and it will be against Jacksonville.
Illegal hand to the face, generally called an offensive lineman in pass protection. You know, Tom, we promised the folks here an air attack. We've seen little from Jacksonville, just two first downs. Goodness. Oh, now it's against Baltimore. He changes it. It's against Baltimore.
Now Ted Marchibroda wants an explanation. Well, maybe we can get David Brinkley to translate for us. He seems to be good with words these days.
Yes. And David Brinkley will always wear a white hat, no matter what he says. Don't you agree?
Illegal hands to the face. Number 73, defense. 5-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's Tim Goad of the Ravens.
Now, the officials really call that a lot nowadays. On the pass rush, they get the defensive lineman gets a hand up underneath the face mask. Goad is the nose tackle. You're going to see him. Let's see if we can pick up anything. That's awful crowded. You can't see anything in there.
Derrick Brown nearly held Eric Turner, too, who was coming on a safety blitz. So Jacksonville perhaps getting away with one and getting the penalty for a first down. Brunel. Across the middle and complete to the 10 and inside. Flag is down as Derrick Brown makes the reception. The 267-pound tight end from Notre Dame, only his seventh catch of the season.
Yeah, he's more the blocking tight end than the receiving tight end. They normally throw the ball to Pete Mitchell out of the tight end position.
Mark Bright has been a busy man here lately.
Holding, number 24, defense. First down.
Brady with a hold. The catch by Derrick Brown will stand.
He's got Andre Rison, and there is a little contact here. Tried to make that short sleeve a long sleeve jersey, and they caught it.
First and goal for the Jaguars, 9-yard line. And again, the ground attack not too productive. Matron Means thrown back by Eric Turner and company. Ray Lewis in there too. And Means with a shove of Lewis.
These two teams play in the same division. They've caught on quickly. And of course, half of Jacksonville's wins last year were at the expense of this football team, even though they were in Cleveland. Now, Lewis wasn't here. I don't know why he's so angry so early, although.
He was here. He was in.
Yeah, he was here.
He was in the state of Florida anyway, playing for Miami. He's from Lakeland and had about 25 friends and family up to see the game today. Brunel with a fake and a roll. Mark Brunel driven out at the 5-yard line by Donnie Brady. Brady took on Brunel one-on-one, and Brady gets him out of bounds.
And, Tom, I think we could see that Mark Brunel is just not healthy. Watch where he's kind of dragging his left leg. Good fake. It tricks everybody, but he's not really running with great authority. Now, he's not a big kid, but he's a very tricky runner. But he's not a threat to run, I don't believe, for the rest of the day. And that might tell the Ravens coaches something. They might change their defensive game plan a little bit, drop a few more in coverage, make it more difficult for him to run.
He's 5 of 8, 106 yards, and an interception. And it's third and goal from the 5. Brunel into the end zone and out of the end zone, incomplete. McCardell was closest to it, defended by Donnie Brady. And it brings up fourth down and a field goal attempt. Mike Hollis, the place kicker of the Jaguars, has hit 10 of 13 field goals this season. Barker will hold for him.
Attempted 23-yard field goal.
Will be a 23-yard field goal attempt by Mike Hollis. And he puts it up and through. So Bell blocks the punt, and the Jaguars get on the board. Not many precincts in, though. Still too close to call.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see.
Oh, feeling safe, being secure. It's why more families rely on Buick LeSabre than any other full-size sedan. Peace of mind from LeSabre.
Folks, please remain calm. It has been confirmed. Everyone can now buy a DSS system for as low as $399. And with a year's prepaid subscription to DirecTV, also get $200 cash back. DirecTV apologizes for any mass hysteria this may cause and stresses again, it's got to be DirecTV, satellite TV at its best. Repeat, DSS, $399, $200 cash back. If we all act civilized, we can get through this thing. Questions?
Next Sunday at noon Eastern, a big doubleheader. First, John Elway leads the AFC's top team, the Broncos, against Drew Bledsoe and the red-hot Patriots. Then Jerry Rice and the incomparable 49ers host the high-scoring Ravens. Or Dan Marino and the Dolphins face the Oilers. Or regional action, the NFL on NBC next Sunday.
Jaguars draw closer to the Ravens, 7-3 with 6:33 left in the second quarter. Hollis ready to kick off with Lewis and Baldwin deep. Jermaine Lewis from the 10. Tripped up and around the 30-yard line and ahead of steam going again. Well, tonight on Dateline, what you don't know about your minivan could cost you, a Dateline exclusive. Then, listen up, Trump. They say this pill can improve your sex life. Is this a miracle drug or medical madness? Watch Dateline Sunday later tonight on NBC.
Is that a yes or no answer that they're looking for? Miracle drug or medical madness? I'll give you the answer next week, Thomas.
And while we attend to the injured Raven, we'll take a timeout. 7-3 Baltimore.
Visa presents Behind the Numbers. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. Why is 100 the most explosive figure in San Diego? Stay tuned.
Take a stroll down memory lane at the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
You crushed my knee.
It was your toes.
You broke my ribs.
It was your nose.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. You sacked me once.
I sacked it twice.
In pouring rain.
No, it was nice.
Ah, yes.
But when you go, don't forget your Visa card, because the hall takes the NFL's best, but not American Express.
See ya, Nitschke.
It's Butkus.
Ah, yeah.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
When the Chargers score a touchdown, a cannon that makes 100 decibels worth of noise turns San Diego into a boomtown. Long before the Chargers, cannons were fired in the NFL, but there were times when a post-touchdown kapow could blow up in your face.
NBC Tuesday, the man about you that brings two television legends back to primetime. Wow! Carol Burnett and Carol O'Connor are Jamie's parents.
And the mashed potatoes.
Oh, they're under the table.
Now that new home.
This is a nightmare!
Don't miss the two Carols on Mad About You's big anniversary, NBC Tuesday.
In Tampa, the Buccaneers used a Michael 23-yard field goal in overtime.
Deshaun Adams was the injured Raven and is back on the sideline as Baltimore puts it in play. Testaverde rolls, throws a screen pass to Bam Morris. Blockers in front, Bam Morris dodging one man, still going. Out at about the 48-yard line. Big gainer on the play. Kevin Hardy finally chased Morris out of bounds. That pass set up very well by Baltimore.
Yeah, you're going to see him roll this way, away from where the screen is. And watch Mickey Washington 25. If he can make the tackle here, they do a great job of stopping this for about 5 or 6 yards. But he misses the tackle. When you see 6'2", 250 coming at you, you do tend to duck your head.
First down, Ravens at the Jaguar 48-yard line after the screen pass, big gainer to Morris.
And Bam has held up very well in this first half.
Baltimore dominating the time of possession over 14 minutes to just under 7 for Jacksonville. Blitz, Testaverde reads it, gets it to Morris out of the backfield, and Morris shakes off two tacklers and scores. Testaverde feeling the pressure from the rushers, just got it off to Morris out of the backfield. He was sandwiched by Hudson and Hall, just shrugged them off and scores the touchdown. 52 yards.
And Jacksonville tried to come with another corner blitz. It was the perfect call for the blitz. He hits the running back on the A circle. And then, again, that leg strength, that fire plug of a running back, and Bam Morris shrugs tacklers is correct.
Stover for the extra point. Puts it through. And Testaverde will get credit for another touchdown pass. He ought to buy Morris dinner, though, for number 22, because Morris did all the work on that one. But Testaverde found his man.
Again, watch the blitz. Here's Bam Morris. He just runs the little halfback circle, and this is the perfect call. You're going to see the safety split. They're consumed by the outside guys, and then watch that leg strength. And they just fall off of him like leaves on a tree.
Watch this. I'll give him 8.5 on that dive into the end zone.
Yeah, too much splash on the entry. Beautifully done by Testaverde. And Bam Morris has been the story in this first half for the Baltimore Ravens. Lugging it and now catching it for a score.
His first receiving touchdown of the season.
Bad half, would you say, in his first start?
Wow. Welcome back, Bam Morris, who gets his first start and makes the most of it. And Vinny Testaverde having another outstanding half. 8 of 11, 124 yards, and now two touchdown passes.
Number 42, Ricky Bell. Number 23, Randy Jordan.
And the numbers on Vinny. Numbers 21 and 22. Touchdown passes for the season.
Yeah, those Matt numbers Stover. Are working. Those numbers are working any half.
Stover with the kickoff. Taken at the 10 by Jordan. And Randy Jordan flag down as he's hit at the 29-yard line. Keith Goganius on special teams makes the tackle. Well, next Sunday, NBC Sports will have more exciting NFL action. Special time, 12 noon Eastern, with the NFL on NBC. A holding call against Jacksonville on the return. Next week, most of you will see Drew Bledsoe and the Patriots hosting John Elway and the Broncos. Should be a great game, Bledsoe and Elway. Some of you will see the Steelers square off against these Jaguars. Others will see the Lions take on the Seahawks. Then in the second half of the doubleheader, most of you will see the 49ers host these Ravens. Others will see Dan Marino and the Dolphins battle the Oilers. Check your local listings for the game in your area. The NFL on NBC next Sunday, starting at 12 noon Eastern time.
Speaking of starts, Jacksonville has showed up late. This has been an ugly first half offensive performance for the Jaguars on a day when they needed a good performance to start this game.
Facing a battered Baltimore defense, they haven't gotten much done. Brunell will be sacked at the 2-yard line. Tim Goad was all over him. Goad, the former New England Patriot player, gets his third sack of the season.
Here's Goad right here. They run a little game. And, Tom, your point is perfect. I mean, this is a beat-up defense that the Ravens are putting on the field. Jacksonville cannot protect their quarterback, number one. They cannot block for the run, number two. The special teams are the only group for Jacksonville that supplied any good field position or any positive things. This is a miserable start for Jacksonville offensively.
They spot the football at about the 4-yard line, second and 18. Short drop, Brunell fires it and is knocked away. Good defense by Isaac Booth, who knocked the pass down intended for Andre Rison.
And now you see Jacksonville just going with the short drop. This is 1-2-3 and run the slant. And Booth is able to get his arm around there. Look, that there was a little contact there, but the official didn't notice, or they were both looking back at the football, allowed it. Another big third down here and very long for Jacksonville.
Kevin Gilbride, the offensive coordinator of the Jaguars, trying to pull it out of the hat here. Brunell runs out of his own end zone, and he's got some green space in front of him. Lowers his shoulder, no feet first slide, and is stopped short of the 20 by Stevon Moore. At least he got him some room to punt the football.
But he is limited in what he can do carrying it. And this is a huge factor for Jacksonville. Brunell has been so good at getting them out of trouble. And again, watch, he's almost like he can't bend his left leg all the way. Stevon Moore with the hit, not enough for the first down.
Whistle's sounding, blowing that Barker punt dead.
And then a flag.
The flag was a little late coming just now. Coming down.
I like that.
False start. False start. Number 52. Offense. Prior to the snap. Five-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Yeah, prior to the snap, but the flag was way after the snap.
Brent Boyer with the premature movement.
Well, that's pretty close.
Know, yeah.
Yeah, that was pretty close.
Fourth and eight. At the 14.
So Barker to punt again from the goal line, and Jermaine Lewis standing at the 50-yard stripe. Good punt. Lewis backpedaling all the way to the 30. Brings it right straight back up the field and gains the 40-yard line before he stops. Nice punt by Barker. Getting the Jaguars out of serious trouble. Randy Jordan then makes the special teams tackle. It was a 56-yard punt. Then a 10-yard return as Testaverde comes back onto the field.
And feeling very good about himself, I might add. Yeah.
So here are the early games as the Bills win a big one in Philly to stay in first place in the East. Kansas City. Miami took care of the slumping Colts. New England had to come from behind and that win over the Jets. Cincinnati with a shocker and 3-0 under Coslett. In overtime, Arizona, a 32-yard Butler field goal upset the Redskins. And Houston looking better and better. Big win over the Saints. Ernest Biner with that carry got about 3 yards. Tampa Bay knocking off the Raiders. What about that?
Goodness gracious. What is going on?
59 points from the Rams. Here it's 14-3 Baltimore, 14-3 Ravens with 3:25 and counting second quarter. Flag down. Ernest Biner. I think the football was blown dead before the fumble. Biner lost about 3 yards, but there are penalty markers.
Offside, number 94, defense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Kelvin Pritchett was offside, and that negates a wonderful play by the defensive front of the Jaguars for a 3-yard loss.
I have a feeling that Jacksonville very happy to see Ernest Biner in the ballgame. Let's see if we can pick up 94. He's right up there. Yeah, he's in the neutral zone. But Biner's had such an impact on this first, Bam Morris has had such an impact on this first half. I don't want to wear him out. They bring Biner in. But this nightmare continues for the Jaguars.
Ernest Biner has the first down, caught from behind and dropped at the 45-yard line by Jeff Loggeman.
Now, see, Tom, what Bam Morris has done is he has softened up this defense. I mean, they turned the offensive line of the Ravens over to Bam Morris and said, fellas, you give me a little bit, I'll get you a lot. And they've done it. Now, this Jacksonville defensive line has lost a lot of confidence. There haven't been too many teams that have pushed them around the field the way Morris and his offensive line mates have done today. And they're in shock right now.
First down at the 46, 2.5 minutes left till intermission. Testaverde a roll and a completion to Eric Green. And Green upended with first down yardage by Robert Massey.
Wow, saw some air there underneath Eric Green trying to hurdle a tackler. Actually, if you're a tackler, I think you don't want him to fall on you. But again, nice little bootleg by Testaverde. Look at the athletic ability here for a guy about 280 pounds.
And that will take us to the two-minute warning. Big Harry Green with a first down reception. Final 2 minutes of the half coming up.
At the Principal Financial Group, you'll find the strength of our investment performance is your 401k retirement advantage. You'll find our flexibility will meet your insurance needs. And you'll find the balance of choice and quality you need in health coverage. For over a century, you've trusted the Principal for strength, flexibility, and balance in retirement, insurance, and financial products. At the Principal, we give you an edge.
Tom Cruise. Mission Impossible. Rated PG-13. On sale November 12th.
Perfect for any game, Domino's has the perfect play. Choose from three delicious crusts. There's classic hand-tossed, crunchy thin crust, or go deep with thick ultimate deep dish. So make the call and have it all.
For hot and wild, call Domino's. Now!
Call now, and you can enjoy a delicious Domino's pizza during the game. And why not add some of Domino's spicy buffalo wings or steaming hot breadsticks?
Last year, more than 6 million people got into a Chevy truck. This year, it'll be even easier. Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
A little chilly to be out on the St. John's River today, some 21 miles from the Atlantic Ocean. River just outside the stadium here in Jacksonville. Beautifully refurbished stadium.
Yeah, hard to believe that what used to sit here was called the Gator Bowl, and what they've done to this stadium is absolutely spectacular. I don't think there is a bad seat nor an uncomfortable seat in this place.
Speaking of uncomfortable, that's the way the Jaguars team feels during this first half. They've been dominated by the Ravens. 11-4 in first downs and 14-3 in score.
Yeah, and of course with a bye week, I think Tom Coughlin expected a great deal more out of his troops than he's getting so far in this first half.
Baltimore with a first down, 35-yard line of the Jaguars. Testaverde throws it away. Eric Green closest to it. As Jeff Loggeman was putting the pressure on Testaverde.
Now here they go with the hurry up, something they're very good at after just being very deliberate and controlling the line of scrimmage inside the 2 minutes. Comfortable doing this.
First time we've seen any no huddle action from Baltimore in this first half. Ernest Biner. Biner crosses the 25, gets it down to the 23 before he's tackled by Dana Hall. Ernest Biner, 13th season from East Carolina, and came in as the number one rusher for the Ravens, 559 yards on the season.
And again, you see the clock in there. That's the play clock, the 25-second clock. And Baltimore still deliberate, even though they're at the line of scrimmage.
Ernest Biner to the 20. Don Davey at the bottom of the stack for the Jaguars.
I can't remember a football game where an offensive line has dominated a defensive line as dramatic as Baltimore has here against Jacksonville.
Just to remind you that Strock and company had a 21-3 lead at halftime last week, lost the game to Cincinnati.
Oh, you would bring it up, wouldn't you?
Biner can't turn the corner. Nice open field tackle made by Aaron Beasley. Beasley, the rookie from West Virginia, who had 10 interceptions to lead the nation as a junior, raised by his grandparents in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. And the Ravens will take a timeout, stopping the clock with 46 seconds left after this nice tackle, Aaron Beasley on Ernest Biner.
This is for Mr. Blanchard, who told me to make something of myself. For Miss Miller, who never let me settle for a C. For my parents, who believe in my dreams. For myself, for my future.
Be all that you can be.
Team 3 Baltimore with 46 seconds left till halftime. And a third down coming up for the Ravens. They have two timeouts left. Ted Marchabrota trying to get more before halftime. And don't forget intermission. Back to New York, our Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC halftime show with Greg Gumbel, Mike Ditka, and Chris Collinsworth. Three wide receiver formation and a quarterback draw. Vinny Testaverde caught by the heels at the 10-yard line by Joel Smenge.
He's run that well. You know, he's done that several times this season. Vinny's a big kid, 6'5", almost 230 pounds, not afraid to run the football at all. Got the defense spread all over the place. And I don't, if you're Tom Coughlin, I don't know where you start at halftime.
And there's our reminder about halftime coming up in 35 seconds.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? You're looking at the Jacksonville Municipal Stadium. Nice cloudless, almost cloudless day. Those are the first clouds I've seen down here.
Right, just drifting in here late in the afternoon. Although a little chilly, and as the sun goes down, going to get a little chillier, especially for a Florida crowd, huh?
Now, the snowbirds come down here expecting 80 degrees and humidity every day. They're going to break out their heavy jackets. They're all now teal or black in color here in the Jacksonville area.
But in contrast to what's happened in the Midwest, I guess not so bad. First down, 10-yard line, 35 seconds and one timeout left. Ball snapped, free play. Incomplete pass intended for Michael Jackson, who has a touchdown catch already. I think Testaverde called for the snap when he saw the Jaguars in the neutral zone to get that free play.
Look at that smile. You know, it's nice to see that smile back on Benny's face. He hasn't had many smiles in his professional career.
Number 69, defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
I believe there is a 69, is there?
No, there is not. But he's got a choice of 99, 56. Well, maybe the total of all those people who jumped off sides adds up to 69.
Maybe it was 56 longer.
That's close to 69, you know.
Still first down, goal to go from the five. Hand it to Beiner, who's tripped up, falls forward to the 2-yard line. Tony Brackens will get credit for the stop as the clock ticks toward 20 seconds. There's one timeout remaining for Baltimore, but they're up at the line and ready to go on second and goal from the two. Testaverde with a roll, calls for a block. Can't get it, steps out of bounds, stopping the clock with 8 seconds. Mickey Washington forced him out.
Yeah, that was a broken play. Couldn't get the handoff, it appeared to me, to Ernest Beiner. So now Baltimore has no choice but to go for the field goal. And Tim Marchibroda is starting to look like George Allen on the sideline. Remember that habit that right. George used to have of licking his fingers like he was about to throw the ball?
What if we can get him to tip the play that way? Does he lick his fingers on a pass only?
I don't think he even knows he's doing it, probably.
21-yard field goal attempt by Matt Stover. And from 21 out, he boots it through the uprights with 5 seconds left till halftime.
With 5 seconds remaining in the first half, Baltimore 17.
As the Ravens up their lead to 17-3, totally dominating the first half here in Jacksonville.
Actually, what's past totally? What I mean.
But they only have 17 points. I mean, if they were totally dominating, seems to me they might have even more points.
Yeah, well, I guess that's the one bright thing you can say for Jacksonville. But Testaverde there talking to Don Strock. And
it's Strock and Marchibroda that have helped Vinny regain that confidence and enjoy playing quarterback and having fun this season. Marchibroda even sat next to him on an airplane ride and said, look, you're so quick to get down on yourself. You're so hard on yourself. When you have success, enjoy it. Yeah. Smile a little bit. And that and I guess a lot of things have combined to have Vinny in his best season as a pro. And this is his 10th year.
And how much of that do you suppose is the baggage from the 86 Heisman Trophy?
Well, the jinx, certainly.
Sure.
Although Ty Detmer is proving that wrong, too, isn't he? But yeah, I don't know. Some of it, there is certainly a correlation, or has been, throughout history. And the much maligned Vinny Testaverde has come alive under the tutelage of Don Strock, the former Miami quarterback, and former pro quarterback Ted Marchabrota as well. Squib kick taken by Ricky Bell. And Bell had it going for a moment, tripped up at about the 35-yard line. So now we're ready for the Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC halftime report, with Baltimore leading Jacksonville 17-3. Let's take you now to New York for the Domino's Pizza halftime report and Greg Gumbel.
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC halftime report, brought to you by Domino's Pizza. For hot and wow, call Domino's. Now.
17-3 Baltimore. We welcome you back to our studio in New York, along with Mike Ditka and Chris Collinsworth. I'm Greg Gumbel. The late games in progress right now. Let's start first with the game in San Francisco. At halftime, the 49ers are leading the Dallas Cowboys by a score of 10-7. 49ers had a 10-0 lead in this game before the Cowboys scored a late touchdown. And you said it right off the bat, the 49ers were hitting people and were fired up at the start of this game.
Well, it looks like two different quarters. I mean, it comes out the 49ers are all over the Cowboys. They're banging them, knocking them around, they're blocking off the ball, they're running the ball, they're protecting the quarter. Second quarter, none of that happened. Steve Young got killed. It looks like the Cowboys now have that attitude, and they're going right after the 49ers. So I don't know, maybe they ran out of plays. You know, they script those plays up there in San Francisco. Maybe that team meeting they had with Bill didn't work. I don't know.
Well, and let's correct. Steve Young didn't get killed, but he's been knocked out of the game with a concussion.
Yeah. Well, he's not killed.
And Troy Aikman with a big drive late in the first half.
Yeah, it sure was. As soon as Emmitt Smith started running the football, all of a sudden that offense started to get on track. Once again, got killed, huh? But when you look at the Dallas, maybe there's some kind of rule that Dallas has to spot San Francisco 10 points before they're allowed to start playing in this particular series.
All right, 10-7, 49ers is the score. In Denver, the Broncos and the Chicago Bears, 14-3 Broncos at halftime. John Elway, a touchdown pass. Terrell Davis's run for a TD. And the game that you are watching, Baltimore is leading Jacksonville 17-3. Out in Seattle, the Seahawks playing the Minnesota Vikings and leading 13-7. We'll bring you the scores and highlights of the early games after a word from the NFL and these messages from your local station.
When I was a kid, I had a lot of dreams, and a lot of people who told me I would never achieve it. Some people even told me I was too small to play football. That was all the motivation that I needed. Today, I have 3 Super Bowl rings and a college degree and a job that I really love, and I'm just getting started. So go on. Just tell me what I can't do now. Never let go of your dreams. Just get out and play football.
Tonight,
we have a dying man on board.
The world's deadliest virus.
We have to assume the worst.
It could kill half the humans on Earth.
Is coming to America.
How could this happen?
We can't bring that plane back to the States.
We're going to shoot down that plane in less than an hour.
We can't let that happen.
The motion picture event of the season.
This is mass murder.
No one is going to die.
Based on John Nance's best-selling novel.
No cost is too great.
Say a prayer for those people tonight.
Pandora's Clock, NBC Tonight.
How can I get through to you? I want the world to know that Hyundai is a whole new enchilada.
But would you listen to me?
No. But you listen to the Jackulous 1996 car book when they tell you that Hyundai has one of the lowest preventative maintenance costs in its class. Got your attention now? I think so.
Then concentrate.
With $1,000 cash back, the Accent is the most affordable car in America. Okay, are your minds finally open?
Now are you ready to get in and drive this baby?
Get in the car. Now.
Here is the future. It is you. It is your wild ideas, your relentless wonder, and your imagination. It is you who will shape the future. You will have the tools and the help of a company who can't wait to see what you can do. Bell Atlantic.
Don't let a cabbie rip you off. Take the taxi test tomorrow at 5.
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's Pizza. For hot and wow, call Domino's. Now.
Well, welcome back. Let's get to the scores and highlights of the early games played today, beginning with the Buffalo Bills getting a win on the road in Philadelphia, 24-17. Ty Detmer into today's game, 4-0 as the Eagles starter. 10-7 Eagles second quarter. Thurman Thomas caps a 16-play drive for the Bills with a 5-yard run. Seventh touchdown of the season, 14-10 Buffalo. The K-Gun operating on all cylinders. Jim Kelly to Quinn Early, 5 yards. It ends a 7-game TD drought for the Bills' big free agent acquisition, 24-10 Bills. 24-17, under a minute left. Detmer looking for the tie, fourth and goal from the 4, but Bruce Smith grabs him for the sack. That's the extent of the Eagles' threat. The final score, 24-17, Bills over the Eagles. This is not only a big road win, but a big road win over a hot team.
No question about it. Coming right off of the win against the Dallas Cowboys, Philadelphia looked like they were going to be very much on a roll. But we talked about it in the pregame show. The Buffalo Bills, as they have done all season long, they've been able to take away the running game other than that game against Pittsburgh with Jerome Bettis. They did it again today. Ricky Waters was a non-factor. Ty Detmer, a one-man show, and Buffalo had enough to win this one.
Well, you talk about battle tough. 6 of the 7 Bills wins have been by 7 points or less this season. In Kansas City, the Chiefs knocked off the Green Bay Packers today, 27-20. Marcus Allen moved past John Riggins into 6th place on the all-time rushing list today. Greg Hill, big day for the Chiefs. 8 yards and a touchdown, 13-3 Kansas City. On Kansas City's next possession, through the air, Bono to Hill. This is good for 34 yards and a touchdown, 20-3 Chiefs. It was 20-6 after a Brett Favre fumble. Hill takes advantage of some poor tackling by the Packers. 24 yards, his 3rd touchdown of the afternoon. Hill has 5 TDs in his last 2 games. Packers scored late to make it close. Kansas City wins it 27-20. Kansas City's still a tough place to go into and win a game, Mike.
Well, they really are. And I think the one thing we talked about, the Green Bay Packers, they've had a lot of injuries with their receivers, but they have not been able to win consistently on the road. They go down to Kansas City. Now they got to go to Dallas. They've got some tough football games ahead of them yet. Everybody's talking about what about when Denver comes there. They've got to win some of these games in between because everybody said they're a Super Bowl team. I don't say that until they prove they can win on the road. But Kansas City put it all together there. And we said the one thing that would hurt Green Bay was a pass rush. Get Favre out of his rhythm. Make him do something he doesn't want to. And Mike Holmgren did not stay with the run in the ball game. He couldn't because he got behind and had to try to catch up. That's the big difference in the football game.
This is the Chiefs' 4th straight win over Green Bay, 27-20. Indianapolis at Miami. The Dolphins win it, 37-13. A couple of more milestones for that man, Dan Marino, today. 50,000 yards passing, 4,000 career completions. 7-3 Dolphins second quarter. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, the first of his 2 TDs, 14-3. Marino, 15 yards to Fred Barnett. Barnett's first touchdown for Miami, 21-3 Dolphins. And it looks like Marino may have a brand new favorite target. He finds Barnett in the end zone again. This one good for 12 yards, 30-6 Miami. They go on to win it by a score of 37-13. The Colts have now lost 5 of their last 6 games. At the Meadowlands, another day of disappointment for the Jets, who fall to the New England Patriots, 31-27. Rich Kotite's team was leading 14-0 late in the first half and driving. Adrian Morrell from 1 yard out scores his 2nd touchdown of the day. The Jets are up 21-0. Under 2 minutes to play in the first half, Patriots get on the board here. Bledsoe from 26 yards out, up top to Terry Glenn, wide open. And it was a 21-7 Jet lead at halftime. 27-24 Jets in the 4th, less than 5 minutes to play. Bledsoe, his 3rd TD of the day, 2-yarder to Keith Byers, gives the Patriots a 31-27 lead. The Jets with one last shot, 4th and 10 from the 11. Frank Reich's pass tipped away by Willie Clay. The Patriots win it 31-27. So the updated AFC East standings, both New England and Buffalo are 7-3. Dolphins and Colts are 2 games back. Now, not a good day for the top teams, or first of all, we'll talk for the AFC Central Division. In Cincinnati, Pittsburgh lost to the Cincinnati Bengals today, 34-24. Bruce Coslett becomes the first Bengals head coach to win his first 3 games. Jerome Bettis surpassed the 1,000-yard rushing mark earlier in the game, scores a 2nd TD from 2 yards out. Steelers had the lead 24-17. Eric Bieniemy with the pitch, 33 yards, and the Bengals tie the game at 24. After a Mike Tomczak interception, the Bengals break the tie. Jeff Blake to Kajana Carter, 12 yards, 31-24. Cincinnati, they go on to win it 34-24. As we said, the Bengals 3-0 now under Bruce Coslett. In RFK Stadium in Washington, the Redskins fall to the Arizona Cardinals, 37-34. Terry Allen came into the day leading the NFL, 15 rushing touchdowns, 20-13 in the 3rd. Here's the first of Allen's 2 TDs today. The Redskins led 27-13. Arizona comes back, 25 seconds left in regulation. Boomer Esiason, 12 yards to Anthony Edwards. They go to overtime at 34. Kevin Butler, signed this week by Arizona, redeemed himself for an earlier miss in overtime. He kicks the game winner from 32 yards out. The Cardinals upset the Redskins. Boomer Esiason, 35 of 59 for 522 yards and three touchdowns today. Not a good day for the top teams in the NFC. Green Bay loses. Washington and Philly both go down, and either San Francisco or Dallas will lose. Back to the scoreboard now. New Orleans, a winner, a loser at home over two of the Houston Oilers, 31-14, the final score. Houston quarterback Chris Chandler back in the starting lineup. He missed last week with a groin injury. Chandler fumbles a snap here, a quick recovery, and Chris Sanders over the middle. Sanders completes a 42-yard touchdown on Houston's first possession. Oilers led 7-0. 14-3 in the second. Chandler to Eric Norgaard on a tackle-eligible play. Oilers 21-6 at halftime. Running back Eddie George, the handoff here. He goes in from a yard out, 28-6 Oilers. They go on to win it 31-14. Now in the AFC Central, the Oilers move to within a game of the Steelers. Don't forget, all three Pittsburgh losses have been within the division. Critical, the Oilers are 6-4 now. Moving on, in Tampa, the Bucs beat the Oakland Raiders today 20-17. Raiders last game in Tampa back in 84, they beat the Redskins in Super Bowl 18. 7-0 Bucs in the second. Jeff Hostetler, Harvey Williams on the halfback option. He hits James Jett, Williams' second touchdown pass of his career. Game tied at 7. 17-10 Raiders in the fourth. Trent Dilfer caps a 14-play drive with a 2-yard TD toss to Mike Alstott. They're tied at 17. 3:04 to play in overtime. Tampa Bay kicker Michael Husted, a 23-yard field goal to win it. Cole Ford of the Raiders missed a 28-yarder with 5 seconds to play in regulation. The Raiders fall. The Bucs win it. The Bucs are now 2-8. The Raiders are 4-6. And in St. Louis, what got into the Rams? 59-16, they beat the Atlanta Falcons. The Falcons are 1-9, and the Rams are 3-7. We'll send you back to the game in Jacksonville after a word from the NFL and these messages from your local station.
Hi, I'm Steve Largent, checking out a little personal history at the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Now I can get right back into the action, thanks to an exciting and unique attraction called the 100-Yard Universe. This theater actually rotates, allowing the fans to follow the players on game day from the locker room to the field. So take a trip to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio. You'll see NFL action like you've never seen it before in the 100-yard universe.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
Wednesday, the Wings season shocker.
I can take it, just tell me.
Sandpiper's bankrupt and I used up all our savings.
Oh, no!
Well, at least she's taking it well. Then a fresh Wednesday Boston Common.
So fresh you'll want to spike it.
And something's wrong with the news radio building, causing strange behavior.
Hey, can I borrow your stapler?
Then the men behaving badly that seemed impossible.
We're getting married on Saturday.
Yow! Bow! You won't miss it. NBC Wednesday.
In the 132-horsepower, 16-valve, overhead cam, 4-wheel, independent suspension, cab-forward, gnarly Dodge Neon Coupe. Dude, say hello to Dodge Neon at your friendly Dodge dealer.
Could Hollywood's fiction become Baltimore's reality? Tonight at 11.
Getting ready to start the second half with Baltimore leading Jacksonville 17-3. Baltimore dominating the first half and hoping not to squander the big lead as they did against Cincinnati a week ago.
Now, you keep bringing that up. Be careful.
Got to convince me. Matt Stover ready to kick off for Baltimore. And fielded and then dropped by Randy Jordan. Picked it back up. And Jordan hit, taken down at about the 15-yard line.
Randy Jordan fields Stover's kickoff.
Well, we promised an aerial show. What we got in the first half was the Bam Morris show, huh?
Yeah, the flyby was the last bit of aerial show that we've had here, Jacksonville. You're right. Bam Morris just totally dominated the line of scrimmage with his offensive line mates. took Jacksonville completely out of the game defensively. Jacksonville's offense could do nothing offensively. After the introduction, I can't say anything good about the Jaguars. That bad. So, I mean, Baltimore's in a situation now where they can name anything they want to do in the second half and should be able to control the football. The only way that Jacksonville can get back in it is if Baltimore turns the ball over a number of times.
James Stewart with a nice run on first down for Jacksonville as we look at our Coors Light halftime stats.
Here's the thing that shocked me the most. Four first downs, just 30 yards rushing, and the leading rusher was Mark Brunell in the first half for Jacksonville. And he didn't have much. He only had 18 yards on two rushes. So I don't know what's happened to this Jacksonville offense, but it's just not here today.
Meanwhile, Bam Morris had 131 yards in total offense for the Ravens. Brunell with a roll, left-hander rolling right, could find no one to throw it to, and is chased out of bounds by Mike Caldwell.
Mark Brunell, the ball carrier.
Here's the first half quarterback comparison with the edge to Vinny Testaverde.
A big edge. He was able to incorporate the run game in the pass game. You know, a couple of dump offs to the tight end, that big throw to Bam Morris in the first half for the touchdown. They didn't run much of the at the line of scrimmage or no huddle offense, but the rest of the offense was just whirring.
And unless Jacksonville can convert this third down, Testaverde will be returning to the field. Brunell shoots it downfield, and in traffic, Pete Mitchell makes a tremendous catch. First down, Jacksonville. Fighting Benny Thompson for the football, the former Boston College tight end Pete Mitchell, who is the fourth leading receiver for this team, makes a wonderful catch.
He was the leading receiver last year, and then they got all these big receivers here kind of gone away from the tight end, but that is great concentration on the football with Benny Thompson right in his face, and a great throw by Brunell.
Mitchell with the reception covers 30 yards, trying to give this Jacksonville offense a spark. Brunell again from the gun on first down. Under pressure, got away. Got away from Goganius, throws it downfield for Risen, and flagged down as Risen was trying to come back for the football and collided with Donnie Brady.
Brady's holding his hands like what I do? He got in Andre Risen's way to come back for the football. This is a no-brainer.
Pass interference. Number 24, defense. Automatic first down.
This is a nice scramble by Brunell. Brady is forced to at least protect against the run by Brunell. Allows Risen to get behind him. And there's the shove. I mean, if Brady doesn't know that's a penalty, boy, he needs some more coaching.
First down for the Jaguars right at the 10. Intended again for Andre Risen, hit hard by Caldwell and Jenkins.
Well, the Ravens came with the blitz. It really didn't have much effect. Again, this is a very catchable ball. And I think throughout his career, if there's been one accusation that sticks to Andre Risen, he'll catch some, drop others. I mean, that's right between the 8 and the 1. And in the first half, of course, the first attempt to him was tipped, turnover to Baltimore, intercepted by Eric Turner.
Second and goal from the 10. Draw play. Stewart.
That's the first bit of cheering these people here in Jacksonville Stadium have been able to get up and do. Again, the Ravens tried to put some pressure with a blitz here. It's picked up beautifully by the Jacksonville offensive line. Buscelli gets two blocks. He turns out the defensive end, then gets a linebacker down the field. Stewart runs untouched into the end zone.
His seventh rushing touchdown of the season. And Mike Hollis tries to add the extra point. And he gets it. So the Jacksonville offense finally comes alive, and suddenly it's a 7-point game after the touchdown by James Stewart.
Shop?
Oh, yes.
How you doing? Franks and beans?
Aisle 5.
Beans and Franks?
Aisle 7.
Hi.
Hi.
Fat free. Nothing but car. Check this out.
You are 1 millionth shopper!
Even at the supermarket, you can do more with the American Express card.
I love this card.
Oh, yes, here we go. Stop sign coming up.
Meet Fred Stark.
A little short.
Fred works for Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Put your turn signal on. We'll make that left turn.
Fred teaches those who train professional fleet drivers the most advanced techniques in driving safety. We think safety is so important, we even created a safe driving video for teenagers.
Dad, relax. You're making me nervous.
Safer, more secure lives.
Oh, boy.
That's the freedom of liberty. Liberty Mutual.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by American Express. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, American Express helps you do more. By Liberty Mutual Insurance, helping people live safer, more secure lives. That's the freedom of liberty. By Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service. And by Jeep, makers of the new award-winning Jeep Grand Cherokee.
With producer Bill Bunnell and director Bucky Guntz, Tom Hammond, Bob Trumpy in the gloaming in Jacksonville, the sun setting. But the Jacksonville offense rising as they finally score a touchdown. And here's the kick by Hollis. Jermaine Lewis. Lewis with another good return. He's done a good job today. Takes it to the 33-yard line where he's tackled by Travis Davis.
Don, I want to go back to that touchdown. You wonder why Boselli was a first-round draft pick. He gets a block on Lyle, and then he gets downfield for another block, and 33 Stewart just waltzes into the end zone. This is an excellent job. They catch him in a blitz, but watch. There's Boselli getting his second block on a simple little draw play. That's the first drive, second half. Jacksonville scores now. Can the defense put a stop to Baltimore's offense here to get the ball back in the hands of the offense?
Key play in that drive, too. The Pete Mitchell catch that on third down and kept him going. Meanwhile, Bam Morris takes up where he left off, bamming his way for 11 yards before he's knocked out of bounds by Eddie Robinson.
Knocked out of bounds by Aaron Beasley and Eddie Robinson.
First half possessions for Baltimore
at the 44-yard line
as they slowly asserted control.
And that's a bad omen, that first run in the second half there. Tom, if I could get a helmet to fit you and you could snap the chin strap, you could get 10 yards in that last play.
Bam with 70 yards rushing now. Here he is again. Makes a nice cut up, and it takes two or three to get him down. Only got two or three yards, but still a pretty nice run considering Don Davey and Kevin Hardy.
And number 64, John Yerkes.
Trying to get him down. San Francisco still by a field goal over the Cowboys. Excuse me, Bob.
I was going to say, still very dominant performance by the offensive line of the Ravens. I mean, Bam cut back, but they had a nice big bow in that defense.
Testaverde with a play-action fake. And wide open Eric Green. And he rambles inside the 35, down to the 33, where he's tackled by Hall and Massey.
What is that, the third time we've seen the little bootleg to the tight end? Here's Green this time on this side. And Testaverde fakes the handoff, and there's been so much running that the linebackers have to commit to stop the run. Green breaks out underneath, and Vinny hits him for an easy completion. All set up again by the dominance at the line of scrimmage.
Third reception. He's too big to come that free. I don't know how you lose him, huh? Baltimore trying to answer the Jacksonville touchdown. Here's Bam Morris looking for a block. Nothing there. Morris tries to go the other way and is taken down. Good defense for the Jaguars. Kevin Hardy, the tackle.
Well, Bam has slowed down. Could you see there when he took the ball? He was a little bit tentative. I mean, his, what did you say he had in the first half? Total for
131.
131. He had about 11 or 12 carries in the first half, and he's beginning to slow down a little bit.
Second and 12 now with a 7-point game here in the third quarter. Testaverde sets up the screen. Bam Morris gets one block, and then the defense prevails. Knocks him out of bounds shy of the 30. Kevin Hardy was bearing down on Testaverde as they set up the screen pass to Morris. Looked good for a moment, but Jacksonville recovered pretty well.
And Tom, again, great job here by Baltimore. Great call. You know, to stop the run, they're going to put more pressure. They're going to come with a blitz and screens, slow down a pass rush or a blitz beautifully. It's executed well. Makes no difference how much yardage Bam Morris gains. It just puts that thought in the head of Dick Geron, the defense coordinator of Jacksonville. We can't just turn everybody loose because they can screen and screen well.
56, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
That was a late flag over at the sideline. In fact, I didn't even see it. And Jerry Markbright calls an unnecessary roughness penalty on Jeff Loggeman that will cost the Jaguars 15 big yards. Another critical mistake by Jacksonville. The veteran Loggeman, the former New York Jet.
All these players now, they get a 15-yard penalty. They may also get a $10,000 fine.
That might be the least of the problems. Sets up a first down for the Ravens at the 17. Ernest Biner has replaced Bam Morris in the Baltimore backfield. Here's Biner. Tough couple of yards to the 15. And Loggeman, incensed at the call, makes the tackle along with Yurkovic.
And Jeff Loggeman.
It's interesting. One of the things that Jacksonville has been doing with Loggeman and with Clyde Simmons and with the Brackens and Smenge, there's four defensive ends, and in pass rush situations, they take Yurkovic out and they play defense with four defensive ends, and Baltimore is taking advantage of that. Just push these guys all over the field.
Simmons has been quiet today, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. Very quiet against his old college teammate, Tony Jones.
Both went to Western Carolina. The Catamounts. Bam Morris back in as Testaverde hits his man at the 5. Derek Alexander, his first catch of the day. Dana Hall knocks him down, but not until it'll be first and goal, Baltimore. So Jacksonville scores off the second half kickoff, and Baltimore coming right back trying to answer.
Fire protection. You saw the offensive line shoot at the legs of the defensive linemen of Jacksonville, get their hands down. Quick set by Vinny. Great throw. Nice completion.
First and goal, ball just inside the Jacksonville 5. Bam Morris hit in the backfield. Got a yard out of it, and I don't know how. Jeff Loggeman hit him first, and then Robert Massey finally got him down as help arrived. Forward progress takes it to the 3. It'll be second and goal.
It's just a zone blocking by the Baltimore offensive line, but actually Loggeman jumps inside, spin move, and is there to make the or assist on the tackle as he spins off. Massey, the big hit, but.
And it appears that the injured player is John Yurkovic, who, of course, had that scary injury in the NFC Championship game playing for Green Bay against Dallas a year ago. We'll take a timeout.
Hi, got your pizza.
I didn't order a pizza.
You didn't order a pizzeria stuffed crust pizza?
Sure didn't.
It's baked fresh every day. Not too thick, not too thin. Just like pizzeria pizza. Mmm, tasty sauce. Ring of cheese that's baked into the crust. It's just $8.99 for a large, but...
Oh, yeah, that's ours.
Thanks a lot.
Discover Pizzeria Stuffed Crust Pizza.
Hi, got your pizza.
What pizza?
On Saturdays, your customers can receive two-day packages from FedEx. Cost? An extra $10.
On Saturdays, your customers can receive 2 to 3 day priority mail packages from the U.S. Postal Service. Cost? $3. And there's no extra charge.
On Saturdays, your customers cannot receive 2 day packages from UPS. Sorry.
So, what's your priority? Priority mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Even though Jeep Grand Cherokee Limited is more sophisticated, more refined, and more luxurious than ever, you can be sure that underneath it all, it's still a Jeep.
This is the NFL on NBC.
John Yerkovich, the injured Jaguar, was able to leave the field under his own power. Second and goal from the 3 for Baltimore. Hand off to Morris, trying the middle and nothing there. Jeff Loggeman and Clyde Simmons combining for the stop of Morris. Yerkovich on the sideline is all right. It was a great fan favorite, of course, with the Packers, and judging by the reaction of the crowd as he came off after being injured, getting that way here as well. Three times inside the 20, the Ravens today. Touchdown and a field goal. They're there again from the 3. It's third and goal. Testaverde throws it into a crowd intended for Eric Green. And Chris Hudson knocked it away.
Hudson, if he catches it, goes the other way for a touchdown. See if we can pick up what happens here. Green is right over here, the tight end. Good job by Hardy holding him up. Now watch 37 come into the picture. Oh, if he catches it, I think he's got a nice little lane to at least get weight on the field.
On fourth down, Matt Stover is on to attempt a 21-yard field goal. He hit from 21 yards in the first half. And he's right on the money again. Splits the uprights down the middle for 3 more. So now it's a 10-point lead, 20-10 Baltimore.
This is it, gentlemen. Finds like these turn careers into legends.
It is a legend. I mean, it's responsible for the entire species.
I can't believe it's in this kind of shape after so many years.
All right, let's get it out of here.
Get the crane!
Wait! They left the keys in it!
The legendary Jeep Cherokee Sport. It could be exactly what you've been searching for.
At Cigna, we care about people who have babies. We care about companies that make steel and about companies that make bread. We care about life and about all that makes life great or possible or just better. At Cigna, we care because it is our business to care. But we also care because, well, we have babies too. Cigna, a business of caring.
And only from Anheuser-Busch. The non-alcohol brew for any occasion.
Earlier on the NFL on NBC, Jimmy Johnson shared his attitude on the Dolphins' recent woes.
Sometimes you've got to be, you know, you've got to be bold enough, and you can't be afraid to fail.
This is going to be a tough fix because this defensive secondary can't cover me.
Don't miss the NFL on NBC next Sunday at 12 noon Eastern.
Ravens answer a touchdown with a field goal, so it's 20-10. Both teams scoring on their first possession of the second half. 11-play, 64-yard drive by the Ravens, resulting in the Stover field goal. Stover with the kick. And Jordan brings it to the 20-yard line.
Randy Jordan fields Stover's kickoff.
Well, tonight, a 747 is carrying the world's deadliest virus.
It could kill half the humans on Earth.
You're going to shoot down that plane in less than an hour.
We can't let that happen.
Say a prayer for those people tonight.
NBC tonight at 9, 8 Central, Pandora's clock. Sold out in Jacksonville as the Jaguars trying to rally from a 17-3 halftime deficit. It's 20-10 at the moment as they take over at their own 20-yard line. Grinnell with a swing pass complete to James Stewart. Stewart takes on the linebacker Mike Caldwell one-on-one and can't get away from the four-year veteran from Middle Tennessee.
Now, one of the things that Kevin Gilbride, is you see the play selection here, Jacksonville well spread. And obviously the dominant rush in the first half, that Kevin Gilbride, they don't have anything that they've really done that they can go back to. They haven't established anything to this point in this game offensively.
Who was it said these were the two most prolific passing teams in the NFL? Nathan Means can't get outside. Tripped up by Caldwell as Caldwell makes two good plays in a row.
And again, this Raven defense is decimated. I mean, here's Caldwell right here. He does a great job of getting out on the corner, and he gives Means no place to go. Sweeps his arm out there to get him on the ground. I mean, I expected the Jacksonville Jaguars to have a big offensive day against this injured defense, and they've done very little.
Third and seven. Similar situation. They hit Pete Mitchell for a first down and a long gainer. Able to keep what turned out to be a touchdown drive alive. This time it's Stewart. Run out of bounds short of the first down by Vashawn Adams.
And see, a good defensive call there. They blitz Stevon Moore, 27, the safety. And it hurries Brunell enough that he has to throw it before the receiver can get deep enough for the first down. I mean, this is a beautifully executed game plan, both offensively and defensively, by Baltimore.
Barker is set to punt. His fourth one of the game. And Jermaine Lewis backpedals to the 20. And immediately twisted down. Good coverage by the Jaguars. Ricky Bell, number 42, made a nice open field tackle after Barker booted it downfield 53 yards.
So I pull into this gas station.
Classic over squeeze. Watch this. Release the hounds! Perfect pump.
2037.
Even at the gas station, you can do more with the American Express card.
NBC Tuesday, now hear this. Frasier's back with an all-new episode, and guess who's after his job?
That would be me.
So what are you going to do about it, Frasier?
I think you know.
NBC Tuesday.
Next Saturday at 1:30 Eastern, Ron Paulus and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame host the upset-minded Panthers of Pitt. Notre Dame football is home on NBC.
Ravens up 20-10 on the Jaguars, 5:20 left in the third quarter. Jacksonville defense without Joel Smenge. He took a shot to the jaws out for the rest of the game. Replaced by the rookie Tony Brackens. Castaverde is sacked. Ball loose. Recovered by Jacksonville. Brackens, the man that makes the play. The Longhorn, the rookie from Texas, knocks the ball free. And recovered by Kelvin Pritchett, number 94.
Man, Brackens was a rocket. He's outside the tight end. Nobody touches him. Bam! Boy, he just leveled Vinny Testaverde. Even though this kid's a rookie, this kid is a great pass rush artist. And when you don't block him, that's going to happen. That is a major league hit by Brackens. And now Jacksonville in shouting range of the end zone.
Brackens, the All-American from Texas, who came out as a junior, the last Southwestern Conference Defensive Player of the Year. Brunell. Incomplete. Intended for McCarta.
I don't know how he misses it. Brunell has had a lot of passes dropped today, this being another one. On the roll, you're going to see McCardale just behind the linebacker. Ooh. Ball is not tipped. It just eats him alive. It gets there so quick he didn't get his hands up, but that, again, is a very catchable pass.
And he's been so good this season. Against his former teammates, McCardale dropped one he should have caught.
He's mad at himself, too. He knows it.
And some mix-up by the Jaguars. Brunell calls a timeout. 5:07 left in the third. Jaguars trying to rally from 10 down.
AT&T presents A World Without Limits. What's the record for the most passes completed in a single game? Stay tuned.
If you're ready to do business on the internet, and you're wondering where to start, then the fastest growing internet provider in America invites you to get on board. Now, no matter what size your business is, AT&T makes it easy to catch the wave.
In an unbelievable display of passing proficiency, the Patriots and Vikings attempted 112 passes, completing a record 71 of them. Of those completions, the Patriots had 45, also an NFL record. In their overtime win, the Pats proved that the line of what is possible can always be moved.
5:07 left, third quarter, 20-10 Baltimore. Jacksonville with a second and 10. From the 19-yard line, hoping to take advantage of the second of any Testaverde fumble of the day. Brunell caught by Risen at about the 15-yard line, immediately hit by Benny Thompson. Now a little scuffle breaks out, and wouldn't you know it, Bad Moon Risen right in the middle of it.
Well, the fellow employees of the Ravens or of Art Modell, both drawing checks out of the same account. Unfortunately, one's got a different helmet color than the other.
But the Ravens are paying him $1 million this year, is that right? And it goes to $3 million next year.
Yeah, all of that bonus money that he got, that $5 million check, counting against the Ravens. In fact, the Ravens only have 52 active players, or 52 players on their roster. They can't afford the 53rd.
Third and six. Brunell from the gun. Rolling. Ducks out of bounds. Took a hit to boot.
Tom, that's a great job by the Raven defense. They did not buy the fact that Brunell was going to run. He had proven that earlier with his bad leg. Lewis kind of hung back a little bit. So did Caldwell. And last year, of course, his running really hurt Baltimore. But watch the linebacker, 56, Caldwell, hang back along with the corner. I mean, they do not commit to go up there to make the tackle. They know he's hurt. They know he's not as big a threat.
Lewis and Brady making the play. So Hollis is out to attempt the field goal on fourth down. 33-yard effort. Hollis hit a 23-yarder earlier. And his kick is good. So for the second time, Jacksonville converts a Baltimore turnover into a field goal. Two Testaverde fumbles recovered by Jacksonville. Twice they have gotten a field goal as a result. And once again, it's a 7-point game before the full house in Jacksonville.
And you know, this is when Baltimore needs Bam Morris fresh. All of his attempts, rushing his receptions in the first half, worn him out a little bit. This is the same situation that they faced against Cincinnati last week, as you've reminded us a couple of times. But now if they could just go out there and again just give it to him, 18 carries and three catches. I mean, over, 147 total offense for Bam Morris. Most of that in the first half. And now when they need him, that lack of hitting condition is beginning to show.
Morris getting a little trim job there before he returns to the fray. As the teams are lining up for the kickoff, and then Morris and company will be out there. Hollis will kick off. Lewis and Baldwin, the deep men, standing at the five. Baldwin from the 12-yard line. Baldwin breaking free for the moment, then caught and ridden down at the 36-yard line by Kendrick Bullard. Well, we invite you to experience the NFL all week long on NFL.com, the official website of the National Football League. For all the tackles and touchdowns and a live game day scoreboard, click on to NFL.com.
Well, that's a pretty picture, isn't it? That kind of wide-angle look at this stadium. Everybody's still here. Still got their fingers crossed. Can the defense stop them here?
Morris. Another good gain on first down. 5, maybe 6 yards. If you can get that on first down, it leaves you with a lot of options.
Well, does it ever. I'm telling you, Williams, 63, the center. Ogden, the left guard at 75. Blackshear, they have done an outstanding job. Orlando Brown, Zeus, T-Bone, Tony Jones, they have controlled this line of scrimmage.
Bam Morris tries the other side. Makes it to the 45-yard line. It'll be about 2 yards short of the first down. Chris Hudson made a nice tackle from his free safety spot.
But Tom, would you agree you're going to see a guard pull out here, do an excellent job, but would you agree that Bam doesn't quite have the same steam now that he did earlier?
Yep.
No, he
didn't explode through that hole, did he?
Right, and in the first half he did. And again, that's just the lack of conditioning, his first start, and how much they've used him to this point in the game.
He's outrushed the Jaguars all by himself. In fact, more than double him. And stopped short of the first down is Bam Morris. Yurkovich and Pritchett combining of the hit of Bam Morris with a big third down play.
Tough choice here now for Ted Marchabrota. He's already sent the punt team out.
Protecting a 7-point lead with 2:20 left in the third. Greg Montgomery.
Greg Montgomery back.
Fourth punt of the day for Greg.
Chris Hudson back for the Jaguars.
High towering kick. Hudson will let it hit. And it takes a backwards bounce, perfect for the Ravens, who will down it at about the 3-yard line. Montgomery nailed one inside the five that time. Randy Baldwin will down it. And the Jaguars backed up with 1:51 left, third quarter, 52-yard punt. Gentle breeze blowing Old Glory here in Jacksonville, which reminds us with Veterans Day coming up tomorrow, a salute to all the veterans who have served our country so well. James Stewart picking his way forward, a little hesitation step, got him a 2 or 3 yard gain. Tim Goad at the bottom of the stack with help from Mike Kroll.
At Jaguars choice here, three tight ends try to spread the defense as best they possibly can, but again, very little blocking up front for a group that actually I think Jacksonville expected a little more run blocking from in this 1996 season.
Tim Goad, a former North Carolina Tar Heel who played 7 years with New England. Again, a three tight end formation as Brunell rolls back to his own end zone. And off the hands of one of those tight ends, Derrick Brown.
Whoa. Well, now we know why he's considered the blocking tight end.
You got it.
Incomplete.
I mean, this one ricochets around in there like that ball is in a pinball machine.
I mean, that was in his hand.
Yeah, that was. That scores a lot of points on the pinball game. Not much in football.
So another crucial third down for the Jaguars. They've converted only 2 of 9. Grinnell's pass caught for the first down. Jimmy Smith. Smith caught it in front of Jenkins, and just as they did on their touchdown drive earlier, they convert a third and long deep in their own territory.
And Tom, this is a tough completion because the Ravens' choice was to rush for drop seven. Now that Brunell is no threat to run, that's well done by Brunell and Smith to make that completion. That was against all odds and a lot of numbers.
Jimmy Smith with a clutch catch from Brunell. First down. Brunell stands in the pocket and delivers to Risen. There is a flag down.
Number 81,
Ron Jenkins pushed Risen out of bounds as he made a nice catch in traffic.
Holding number 24, defense, penalties declined. First down.
Brady's hold declined, and another long gainer by the Jaguars in the books. Brady, number 24, called for the hold. Doesn't matter. Risen had made a nice catch over on the sideline.
Well, again, the Ravens, four-man rush, seven defensive backs here. No threat of Brunell to run at all.
Final 25 seconds of the quarter. Stewart hit behind the line, scrambles forward to the 40. Tripped up by Cedric Clark.
Who? Cedric Clark. Who?
One of the newer newcomers, just signed on the 31st of October. Final seconds of the third quarter ticking away, and the Jaguars will not run another play. Third quarter ends with the Ravens clinging to a 7-point lead, 20-13 over Jacksonville. We'll be back to Jacksonville after these messages from your local station. Jacksonville with a productive third quarter to draw within 7 of the Ravens. And how desperate have the defenders of the Ravens been? Well, Cedric Clark, who made that last play 10 days ago, was on the New Orleans practice squad. Was a 7th-round draft choice by the Raiders before being released by them earlier this season, a rookie from Tulsa. Just looking for warm bodies, Ted Marchibota and company.
Anybody who has ever played defense.
Second and 6 for the Jaguars from their own 40. Brunell's pass. Was it caught? Mitchell, did he hang on? Yes, he did. The sure-handed Pete Mitchell holds on despite the hit from Stevon Moore, and the Jaguars have a first down.
Actually, a very good protection here, Tom, allows Pete Mitchell to get out and open. Stevon Moore, the free safety, is the man in coverage. Excellent hands, great catch, does hang on to it.
He's had a couple of key ones today, only 2, but they have been at crucial times for the Jaguars. Just short of midfield. Brunell winds up, sends it deep downfield, just out of the reach of Jimmy Smith, who had gotten by the defender Isaac Booth.
Actually, I was surprised he went by Booth that quickly. I mean, he just flew by Isaac Booth. He may be one of the real secret weapons for the Jaguars. I mean, nobody knows about this kid or what he can or can't do, but Jacksonville likes him a lot. Man, he just rocketed down the sideline, just overthrown.
Brunell got room to run. Dodges one man, cuts to the outside, and finally taken down by the shoulder pads at the 18-yard line by Eric Turner. It didn't look like he was hurting too badly there as he did a little hop, skip, and jump all the way downfield.
But look how reluctant he is to run. I mean, he would much prefer to throw this. He does a great job of avoiding Donnie Brady coming up right there. Brady misses him. He doesn't want to run. But again, that is a huge play in this situation. And last year he did it in both Jacksonville wins against the Browns. Now Ravens.
34 yards on that one by Brunell, who is the Jaguars' second leading rusher behind James Stewart this season. Try to call a timeout, and the snap got right in his face. And he throws a completion to the 5 and to the 4, Pete Mitchell. Whoa, it's better to be lucky than good sometimes. His hands were in front of his face calling timeout, and the ball got there.
See the smile on Brunell's face? There's the timeout signal. Wydell, 79, still snaps it. Something out of nothing. Isn't there a song like that? How about that? All that planning, all that practice, let's put it in the game plan.
Well, Brunell has been lining up exclusively in the shotgun lately, but here they'll go to the I formation. First and goal from the 4. Stewart can't get away. Tackled by the ankles by Stevon Moore. This whole thing set up by the 34-yard Mark Brunell run, which is the longest of his career.
Ravens safeties are heavily involved in this red zone defense for Baltimore. This is a great spot to try to hit a tight end. I mean, if your safeties are cheating up their line of scrimmage to stop the run, that's when you find that tight end open behind him.
You better locate Pete Mitchell than 83. He's been a key target for Brunell. And there is Mitchell, tight end at the top of the screen. Brunell looking, fakes the pass, and can't get away from Benny Thompson, who spins him down.
Oh, and he kind of spun on his leg, too. Did you see that, Tom? Again, reluctant to carry the ball. Looking. Now watch when Thompson hits him. He hits him high, and he kind of puts a lot of pressure on that right leg.
I thought he might have had Stewart open at the goal line, but elected not to throw it his way. So it's third and goal. Now the ball all the way back to the 7. From the gun. Under pressure. Throws for the corner. Incomplete. Intended for McCardell. Donnie Brady defending.
Well, the Ravens' choice again to put as much pressure as they possibly can on Brunell. Actually, it's picked up pretty well by the offensive line. And then he's just thrown for a spot in the end zone, right in the corner of the end zone. McCardell beats Brady, but can't make the catch, keep his feet in bounds. Another field goal attempt.
Hollis will attempt it. 24-yard effort. Didn't look too pretty, but got through the uprights. Hollis is 3 for 3 in this game. Brunell and company pull within 4. Wanted more.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by MetLife. Get Met, it pays. By Nike. And by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Tom Hammond, Bob Trumpy from Jacksonville, where a 13-play, 89-yard Jaguar drive results in a field goal, 20-16 Baltimore with 11-11 left. Hollis ready to kick. Randy Baldwin along with Lewis deep. Lewis. Good coverage by Jacksonville that time. Lewis to the 24-yard line. Stopped by Randy Jordan. Well, next Saturday, 1:30 p.m. Eastern, the tradition of Notre Dame football returns to NBC. Ron Paulus, the Fighting Irish, hosting the Pitt Panthers. Pitt and Notre Dame next Saturday, 1:30 Eastern, here on NBC. Penalty flag down after that last kickoff return. Here's Jerry Mark Bright.
Personal foul, number 88, on the return. Unnecessary roughness. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Brian Kinchin. Unnecessary roughness.
On a tight end, I want proof.
They're just naturally rough, the ones I've known.
I want proof. I don't believe it. Neither does Ted Marchibota. He's not, you know, a lot of.
I think
quality.
I saw him say tight end. Couldn't be.
Yeah. He's known a lot of quality tight ends in his career.
I didn't know there wasn't such thing as that.
Absolutely.
Penalty will put the football, once they set it down, at about the 12-yard line. And the crowd trying to rally the Jaguar defense. Shift by the front of the Jaguar defense. Testaverde heaves it downfield and too far. Floyd Turner closest to it, but it overshot him by a pretty wide margin. And Jacksonville shifting its defense after you could see Testaverde making some hand signals, reading the defense, and then they shifted just before the snap of the ball.
A miscommunication there. Good performance by Vinny. Great numbers, but miscommunication between quarterback and receiver on that play. You're right, Tommy. It was not even close.
Hand off to Bam Morris. Another tough run by Morris, dragging Jaguar would-be tacklers with him to the 20-yard line before Eddie Robinson finally puts him down for good. There's Bam Morris, who is a little slow getting up. And, of course, Eddie Robinson, who played in the Southwestern Athletic Conference for Alabama State. I asked him about the first time he ever faced Eddie Robinson, the Grambling coach. So they beat him so badly, he didn't want to say hi. Here's the no huddle. Bam Morris with a quick run. Flag down. Morris would have a first down if it stands.
Bam Morris carries. Brought down by Kenny Bell.
Yeah, it looked like Jacksonville was trying to change their defensive front. Ravens catch him trying to make the change.
Twelve men on the field. Defense. Penalty is declined. First down.
They'll take the Bam Morris run as they go to the no huddle, really for the first time, and they catch Jacksonville trying to substitute on defense.
And that's certainly one of the aspects of the at the line of scrimmage offense. We want to determine as an offense what defensive personnel we face.
Testaverde, wide open, catch made by Alexander. Derek Alexander, who has been rather quiet today, tackled immediately by Ricky Bell. Alexander came in with 41 catches, second on the team.
Just a simple square, and he pushes the corner back and pushes him back well. Good timing by Vinny Testaverde. And great presence here by this offense, you know. Jacksonville's come close, kept their heads. Vinny's in control.
First down at the 41. Morris on the handoff, stopped by Tom McManus.
Now he's certainly been the story of the game, has he not?
Yep. Both running and receiving. As we review some of the scores and some surprises, and why not? I mean, if Holyfield can beat Tyson, why can't Cincinnati beat Pittsburgh?
Absolutely right.
Blitz coming in. Doesn't get there in time, but it does cause Testaverde to throw prematurely incomplete. Jurkovic was first to arrive on the scene, and all the troops were coming, including Mickey Washington from a corner.
Jurkovic is again untouched. You know, that late movement by the defensive front of Jacksonville created just a little bit of confusion in the pass blocking scheme of the Ravens, Jurkovic takes advantage of it. But Vinny does a good job. Just throws it away.
Third and seven. Testaverde's pass is caught by Alexander. Testaverde drilled it right in the only space available, and Alexander latched onto it for a gain of 22 yards and a Baltimore first down.
Alexander runs a great pattern here, and Vinny Testaverde stays with him, doesn't give up on him, even though there is excellent coverage right in front of him. I mean, there's no question that Robert Massey is right there, but I like the way Vinny shuffled up in the pocket, kept his eye on the receiver, and just powered it in there for a completion.
And pinpoint placement by Vinny that time.
This is a different Vinny Testaverde.
Quickly raises up and calls a timeout, does Testaverde. Trying to beat the play clock, did he? Yes, he did. Timeout, Baltimore.
Another great job, presence of mind by Vinny Testaverde.
First time out of the half taken by the Ravens, who lead by four.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Call now to enjoy a hot and delicious Domino's Pizza during the game. For hot and wow, call Domino's now.
Eighth play of the Baltimore drive coming up for Ted Marchibroda. They've covered 50 yards in seven plays and run the clock down to 7:49. There you see, with a four-point lead. First down, 34 of Jacksonville. Bam Morris to the 30. Loggeman the tackle.
But almost from behind. Again, the recurring theme this day has been the control of the offensive line of Baltimore on Jacksonville's defensive line. Look at that push. My goodness gracious. Led by the kid, Jonathan Ogden. First-round draft pick who was a starter 30 seconds after they picked him. They have absolutely mashed the Jacksonville Jaguars defensive line.
Ogden, the Outland Trophy winner. First Raven drafted. Brian Pinchin, the tight end, breaks free for a moment and dives inside the 15-yard line. Mickey Washington covering Pinchin. Kevin Hardy was putting the pressure on Testaverde.
And Aaron Beasley, number 21, misses a tackle. Kinchin on the left side sets up like he's going to pass protect. No, it's not 21. It's a 28. Dana Hall misses the tackle there. Big, good job done by Brian Kinchin. He doesn't catch it often. And he, with a no protection out there, he did an excellent job for a first down pickup.
Play action fake from Testaverde, who rolls, being chased by Loggeman. Throws for the end zone. No good, out of the end zone. Catch was made, but not in bounds. Floyd Turner could not come down in bounds with the football, though he did hold on.
This is very well done. Loggeman, 56, is in hot pursuit of Testaverde. And you see 87 at the top of the screen just releasing. Look at the strength of that arm.
Close.
Yeah.
Closer than I thought.
Testaverde has always had a strong arm. He has never been in a situation where he's been in complete control of an offense. This is a brand new edition of one Vinny Testaverde, Tom.
An impressive return to Heisman form. Look, that'll cost him 5 yards. Tony Jones came sprinting across.
False start, number 66, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Well, I guess if you're going to do this, you want to make no doubt about it. And he fires out of here like it's going to be snapped on the first sound on Clyde Simmons. He went right by him. Let's make it no doubt.
I'd say Tony had gotten the best of his former Western Carolina teammate, Simmons, today.
I agree. We've not called Clyde Simmons' number or name very much at all.
Second and 15, Testaverde for the end zone. Touchdown.
Oh, man.
Alexander.
Tom, did you see the way he looked the safety off? Oh, man, this is pretty. Who is this guy, really? wearing number 12. Tell me the truth. I mean, I talked to him last night. I know that's Vinny. Here is the deep slant, a double move run by Alexander, which is beautiful. And the thing that makes it work is that the quarterback, Vinny Testaverde, looks that safety off just to, long enough, and Hall can't get over there to be a factor in the reception.
Matt Stover for the point after. Puts it through. Impressive drive engineered by Vinny Testaverde, who throws his third touchdown pass of the game.
Quick look, looks over left, comes back to the receiver. Those are the details that coaches dream about that come through on the field.
While we were away, Vinny Testaverde was all smiles over on the Baltimore sideline after throwing his third touchdown pass, engineering an 11-play, 88-yard drive that took nearly 5 minutes. Impressive. Stover's kick, fielded by Jordan, flag down. So is Jordan at about the 23-yard line. Tackle by Ed Sutter.
Tom, if we go back to the touchdown, here's the man who was influenced. They run a tight end on the square end, and Vinny keeps looking right at the safety. That allows Alexander the double move, deep slant. I mean, Don Strzok has got to be so impressed with this. See the way he makes the safety hesitate by looking at the tight end? There's no underneath or inside help for the corner. Touchdown. Third of the game, 23rd of the season.
Number 35 on the return, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Illegal block by Lachey Maston will penalize Jacksonville. Don Strzok, he might want to frame a couple of those.
Well, you know, when you coach a quarterback, you say, Vinny, we need to influence the safety somehow, give him a look. I mean, this is picture-perfect execution by Vinny Testaverde, especially on that play.
Testaverde for the day, 16 of 24, 237 yards and three touchdowns. Brunell trying to answer and has a quick strike to Jackson. Willie Jackson to the 35-yard line, stopped by Eric Turner. Big game for Jacksonville, and an injured player is Goganius.
A 25-yard game.
Keith Goganius, the former Jaguar.
Now they stopped the clock for him, so he's going to have to go off the field. And of course, the Ravens now are going to be in their prevent attitude. That is, make sure no one catches it deeper than you are. And keep him underneath so you can at least make the tackle, have the clock work in your favor. 5:56 to go. Man, I'm impressed with Vinny Testaverde. We've seen him twice this season, opening game of the season, now the 10th game of the season. This kid has had a sensational year to this point.
No huddle offense for the Jaguars. Brunell from the shotgun. Ducking under is McCardell, and finally out of bounds for the first down at the 46-yard line. Adams knocked him out, and then the flag comes after the fight breaks out.
Against former teammates. Manny Thompson is taking on a couple of guys today. Maybe he's mad because Risen and McCardell got all that big money. Benny had to stay with the Ravens and settle on what he got from previous years.
McCardell's doing a little jawing there, but he's basically been a non-factor today.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, both sides. 37, Baltimore, 87, Jacksonville. Penalties offset. First down.
Watch what McCardell does with the football, Tom. Kind of shoves it back in Benny Thompson's face, and then he takes offense at it.
Well, that's a taunting penalty. Should have been called on McCardell to start with.
Yeah.
Looked to be equally guilty in the scuffle, but the taunting call is supposed to be a penalty.
Now, hockey, they have first-in penalties, right? If you start it, I right. agree with you.
Brunell ducks away from trouble, rolls and delivers, and the catch made for a first down by Andre Risen. Risen was parked over there on the boundary. Hard to see. Brunell finally did and got him the football.
Andre was waiting patiently for Brunell to pick him up.
First and 10, Jacksonville, the 41-yard line.
Meanwhile, Dallas and San Francisco tied at 17, 2:45 left. Brunell. Rison couldn't hold on, went upstairs to get it, had a hand on it, but couldn't hold on, and then was hit by Dorian Brew.
Was that a one-handed effort by Andre Rison? I only saw his right hand go up to try to make a catch here. That ball was not perfectly thrown.
Brunell, 16 of 27, as you see that tie score. San Francisco and Dallas. Second and 10. Brunell on target once more. Catch made by Rison for another first down. This one at the 26-yard line.
Now, all the Jacksonville fans are saying, now, why couldn't we do this all day long? Well, the Baltimore defense, you see seven defensive backs, a four-man rush. The idea is you're up by 9 points. You're going to use the sideline, the clock, and make sure that nobody breaks deep of a defensive player for a quick score. You just hope you can slow them down.
Another completion to Mitchell. Immediately hit by Thompson. And the hurry up in progress with the clock down to 4:41. Catch at the 5, McCardell. That looked like the AFC's leading receiver on that one. Turner covers him, but McCardell with a brilliant catch.
Yeah, that was a tough catch. Stretched him out. He made it. And Rison didn't make the tough catch on the previous one.
First and goal at the 5. Brunell rolling. Can't get away. Ridden down by Benny Thompson. Loss on the play. Back to the 9-yard line.
And Benny Thompson is going to play that spy linebacker, even though he's a defensive back, and make sure that Brunell can't run down here in this red zone situation. He's done a great job.
Second and goal. Loss on the play of about 4 yards. And Jacksonville takes a timeout.
Well, the fans are booing, but there's certainly nothing wrong with this.
Jacksonville needing a touchdown to get back in it.
All right. Take care of yourself and call us.
Everything okay?
Now he's going to France to study painting.
I thought he was into photography.
Well, now he wants to be Monet. Last year in iced tea business, now this. I mean, why can't he find one thing and stick to it?
Well, he is your dad.
At Aetna Retirement Services, we not only help you build assets, but manage them as well. Build for retirement, manage for life.
You can't have pool parties when I'm on the road. This is what happens. You know what I'm saying?
Have a regular party, but you can't have any more pool parties. Look at this, the filter's messed.
This is Ford Escort. It's new and it's nifty. It's made for the smart, the intelligent thrifty. It's new out and in, has airbags for two. Even anti-lock brakes are available. Ooh, the trunk, it is huge to hold tremendous treasure. And if your treasure is of stupendous measure, the rear seat folds down to let bigger things in, still leaving room for your next of kin's kin. It has all the what's-its and gidgets, to put it concisely. And Escort's right price should suit you quite nicely.
Next Sunday at noon Eastern, a big doubleheader. First, John Elway leads the AFC's top team, the Broncos, against Drew Bledsoe and the red-hot Patriots. Then Jerry Rice and the incomparable 49ers host the high-scoring Ravens. Or Dan Marino and the Dolphins face the Oilers. Or regional action, the NFL on NBC next Sunday.
Jaguars down to their final timeout, trailing 27-16 with 3:55. Second and goal from the 8. Screen pass, Stewart, touchdown.
Great call. That was worth the timeout.
And another fight breaks out in the end zone. And now fans throwing beer or some sort of liquid on the players and officials. Somebody's been thrown out of the game, I think. Might be. Now the fans are being lectured by the officiating crew.
My card, Tom, says, well, they separate everybody.
Right.
Down by five, you go for two in this situation, too. That was a great call by Kevin Gilbride, the offensive coordinator. Ravens again with a four-man front, seven defensive backs. As Tom Coughlin's trying to get his guys back on the field.
And order finally restored. It's going to take a while to sort things out, though. And we would expect the Jaguars to go for two.
Yeah, did you see? Well, Pacelli's going back on the field. Let's see what Jerry Markwright and his crew kind of decides. They're down in the end zone here trying to figure out exactly what they're going to do. Maselli threw a punch or two, and he's leaving the field. Now, if he's thrown out, that's their best offensive lineman in a big two-point conversion situation.
We have fouls on both teams after the play is over.
We knew that.
Nothing new yet. You're right.
Number 87, Jacksonville. Number 37, Baltimore. Unnecessary roughness on both. They offset during the dead ball. First down.
All that?
Business as usual.
Well, Baselli went off the field. Now he's coming back on. I think he thought he got thrown out.
I could have sworn I saw one of the officials give him the thumb, but evidently he thought so, too. Yeah. He's right back out.
And the offense is on for a two-point conversion, so.
Jeff Novak had replaced Boselli at the left tackle spot.
Wait a minute, they're still talking here, though. Jerry Markwright is still out there with an official. No, that's it, no ejections.
Ball marked ready for play. There's Novak, who is on the field in the huddle. And Boselli returns when his number wasn't called. Two-point conversion upcoming. It's 27-22, 3:50 left in the game. We're now changing it. Play clock to one. Did not get it off. Crucial mistake by Mark Brunell. Cost them 5 yards.
Offense. 5-yard penalty. We'll try from the 7-yard line.
They still got to go for two. I mean, it makes no difference, but and it may give them a little bit of a
more passing room.
Yeah, more room. I mean, I'm not so sure. I wouldn't call the screen again because I think I've counted this right. Baltimore has 6 defensive backs in the ball game, 4 linemen, 1 linebacker. So let's see what they come up with. Actually, this may help. It's not what they wanted, but this may help.
I'm not so sure.
4, 5, 6. No, they got 7 DBs in there again.
So from the 7, the 2-point conversion. Brunell, the shotgun. Lofts it to the end zone. No good. Out of the end zone. Pass carried McCardell well beyond the border anyway. Even had he caught it, it would have been no good. So the 2-point conversion double misfires. And it remains 27-22.
Now, this is what's happened to this football team. The Jaguars, they hang close. And in the latter stages of the fourth quarter, something just goes awry and they don't win.
Well, like a young team whose
yes.
average age is 26 and who are in their second year of existence.
Now watch this touchdown. This screen is beautifully executed. It's against the 7 defensive backs. Okay, just one block is all that's necessary to get Stewart in the end zone for the score. That was a great call. And then, again, the learning curve. For a young expansion team, the Jacksonville Jaguars average 26 years per player. And Tom Coughlin is more of a teacher than he is a coach right now, teaching him how to play in the NFL. It's a never-ending battle.
with 3:50 left, are you onside kick?
The answer to that question is yes. But then Baltimore may understand that too. Man, I'm not so sure. 3:50 left. One timeout. No, I think I'd kick it away. I'm going to change my mind.
All right. You're allowed that. And it looks like Hollis will indeed kick it away. At least that's the way they've lined up.
Number 84, Jimmy Lewis. Mike Hollis for the Jaguars.
Send it deep. Baldwin to the 24. Here's a reminder that following the game on most of these stations, it's Dateline Sunday. Then the must-see comedies of Third Rock from the Sun, followed by Boston Common, plus the world's deadliest virus is airborne and headed our way. Pandora's Clock, the motion picture event of the season, all coming up tonight on NBC. Viewers on the West Coast will see these shows at their regularly scheduled times. From the 25-yard line, Ravens have 3:41 to kill to hold on for their fourth victory of the season. Bam Morris, nothing. Maybe eked out a yard. Tom McManus with the tackle for Jacksonville.
Stop by Tom McManus and Eddie Rush.
If you're Ravens here, you want Jacksonville to have to use that last timeout. You'll use every tick of the clock. No hurry whatsoever. Hang on to the football. Nothing fancy.
Baltimore hoping to avoid a repeat of last week and hold on for the victory. They're up by five. Fake and a roll by Testaverde. Throws back on the screen and short hops. Bam Morris incomplete.
Probably a good thing. It was not open. Actually, that was well defensed. Eddie Robinson, number 50, was right over there next to Bam Morris. Eddie read it and read it well.
Robinson, whose wife Tunja celebrated her birthday yesterday, a Jacksonville kindergarten teacher.
Rollout, throwback. Excellent job by Eddie Robinson just snipping that one out. Actually, that helps Jacksonville stop the clock with that incompletion.
So Robinson and company now try to stop the Jaguars one more time. Third and long. Showing blitz. Robinson doesn't come. Testaverde's in trouble, though. Throws it away.
Well, that could have been intentional grounding. I don't know why Jerry Markwright did not call that, and the referee is the only referee, the only official that can call that. Lagerman saying it was a... It was a lateral.
He was in the pocket.
He was in the pocket. He throws it out there. He throws it just in front of the...
Bracken's had a hold of him. That's grounding.
Oh, that's... You know, two throws stopped the clock. 2:44 left for Jacksonville.
Jaguars will get a chance. Montgomery averaging only 31 yards a punt.
Do you go after this punt?
Oh, I let him punt it away.
Yeah, I agree.
With the return on with Chris Hudson. There's Montgomery. They have blocked one today. Return set up this time, though, as Hudson takes it at the 24. Got by one, got by two, and got a block. Hudson dancing. There is a flag down on the field as Hudson is to the 44-yard line. Knocked out of bounds then by Brian Kinchin. 51 yards on the punt and a good return by Hudson. Penalty all important here. Against Jacksonville. Very costly. They would have had excellent position. Coughlin calls for a face mask. We'll get no relief.
Jacksonville on the return. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Well, he didn't identify the culprit. Very costly penalty. Instead of having the ball across the 40, they're going to be back at the 34-yard line. Mark Brunell, Bob, is closing in on 300 yards passing today. Most of that in the second half, 15 to 21, 189 yards.
I'm interested to see the deployment here of the Ravens defense. One, two, no, they've got five defensive backs. They've gone away from the prevent here.
Pass complete to Mitchell. He'll have a first down about the 47-yard line. Eric Turner and Vashawn Adams. Mitchell, boy, he has been the clutch receiver for Coughlin and the Jags today. Diving catch. No good. McCardell thought he had it.
There was just enough pressure into the face of Mark Brunell. See if we can pick up whether McCardell gets down here and gets it. It kind of looked like it skipped.
Yeah, I agree.
But just enough pressure by James Jones, number 97 of the Ravens, and Brunell couldn't quite zip it out there.
2:02 approaching the two-minute warning. They'll get one more play. Brunell over 300 yards passing. Wide open down the sideline. Smith, and Smith is out of bounds just inside the 30. Adams knocked him out on the final play before the two-minute warning. Officially 1:51 left, 25-yard strike.
What a piece of that championship!
Saluting coaches on the field and in the classroom, Staples The Office Superstore presents the Coach of the Week sweepstakes. Congratulations to the Eagles' Ray Rhodes, whose victory over the Cowboys makes him the Staples Coach of the Week. And to George Washington High School, the winner of $5,000 in school supplies plus a visit from Coach Rhodes. For your chance to win, send the following information to Staples Coach of the Week sweepstakes, Box 2242, Framingham, Massachusetts, 01702.
It starts with a full quarter pound of beef, with fresh toppings, our chef sauce, on a bakery soft roll. McDonald's Arch Deluxe. If it were any more grown up, we'd need to check your ID. Oh, thank you. It's McDonald's with a grown up taste.
There are those who worry about the future. And those who don't have to.
Tonight on an all-new Third Rock, Sally visits an all-male bar.
You look just like a real woman.
That's what I was going for.
And it's love at first sight.
Oh, yeah.
Just one problem. Sally's new boyfriend thinks she's a man.
Now slip out of that dress.
Oh. Plus, Lorraine Newman guest stars in an all-new Third Rock, followed by an all-new Boston Com on NBC tonight.
Last completion, Brunell to Jimmy Smith. Here's Jimmy Smith. They're running a zone, but this linebacker gets really influenced by the slot guy, and they leave Jimmy Smith alone on the sideline. And Brunell does an excellent job of even identifying he's over there. I mean, look at all the rest of the Jaguar helmets and jerseys. He still finds him. Nice pickup.
Don't miss the 25th anniversary of the Walt Disney World.
Brunell and the Jaguars trying to pull out the victory. 333 yards passing by Mark today, ensuring he will stay atop the NFL passing yards standings. 1:51, one timeout left. Brunell's pass.
They're saying the ground caused the ball to come loose. That was a big hit by Adams. Ted Marchabrota is saying he had no control of that. Now, this is a perfect spot for the use of instant replay, whether the second foot was down. No catch.
I thought, actually, that was the proper catch. I didn't think he held on long enough. Boy, he took a shot. You don't blame him for not holding on.
And you're looking again for the second foot down, no question. But wait a minute, he had that ball when he was on the ground. He's got it. He still has it. He hits the ground and it bounces out. Did he have control?
Yeah, I don't know if he had control or not. That's a tough call.
I'm not sure replay would have reversed that call. Yeah.
So second and 10.
It was still a great catch.
Was.
Or non-catch.
Yeah. Ball on the 29-yard line. 5-point game. Outlet receiver is Mitchell. He's to the 20. Stopped by Benny Thompson. It'll be third down and about a yard.
Now, Tom, I would suggest call the timeout here on the third down and one. Use it here, but they're not going to.
Pass is caught by McCardell. Despite the hit by Eric Turner, it'll be first and goal, Jacksonville.
That was a great throw by Brunell.
For the second straight week, the Ravens in danger of losing in the last minute of the game after blowing a big lead. Brunell, quarterback draw, pounds to the one. Timeout, Jacksonville, their final timeout, stopping the clock at 46 seconds.
We got to show you two plays, not one. The catch by McCardell, again, in the slot, does a great job, gets around the underneath guy. This is the same one as before. Takes the big hit, and now a great call on the quarterback draw. If Brunell is healthy, I think he scores. Actually, Fredericks does a great job of, on the game, just falling into the tackle. Now they've used their last timeout, 46 seconds to go. And the Ravens, Tom, for most of this fourth quarter have been with that 4-7 defense, seven defensive backs.
Well, this could just cut the heart of that Baltimore team, a repeat of last week.
And what would it do for Jacksonville, the way they started this football game?
And what a lift it would give.
Yes.
The Jaguars with Brunell well over 300 yards passing. They come with three tight ends. You see one of them, Rich Griffith, joined by Pete Mitchell and Derek Brown. The ball's at the one-yard line. 46 seconds, no timeouts. Baltimore leads 27-22. I formation. Fake it. Brunell still has the ball. Mark Brunell, touchdown! Again, the Jaguars will go for two as Andre Rison and Keenan McCardell with a little taunting of their former teammates after going up 28-27, 41 seconds left. They'll try to make it a three-point margin here. Brunell's pass is good for the two-point conversion to McCardell.
He was uncovered. It looked like the Ravens wanted to call a last-second timeout because they realized that they didn't have the right defense in there. But let's go back to the touchdown on the quarterback sweep. It is designed. You're going to see him come right at you. An excellent job of faking. You see the guard pull out, make a decent block at number 62. Coleman. Brunell knows he's got it. What a comeback. And the two-point conversion, you're going to see nobody in coverage on the slot man. There he is right here. Benny Thompson tries to come out and cover for it. You also saw 36 Isaac Booth try to call a quick timeout. Brunell recognized it. And you realize if the Ravens lose this game, they will be 0-4 in the division. and 0-5 on the road this year.
And for the second straight week, will have blown a big lead to lose in the final minute.
Whatever Coughlin said to this team at halftime, package it, sell it.
Vinny Testaverde's had a great day, but what about Mark Brunell? Back from the dead in the first half. For the day, Brunell has passed for 356 yards and run for 59 more.
On one leg. He's run on one leg. Tom Coughlin told us, he said, I want people of character on this football team. Character has shown and shown brightly on the Jacksonville side of the ball in this second half. He did not give in a lick.
Hollis to kick off. Lewis. Jermaine Lewis nearly broke free. Wrestled down at the 27-yard line by Eddie Robinson. Don't forget, following the game, most of these stations, Dateline Sunday. Then the must-see comedies, Third Rock from the Sun and Boston Common, plus Pandora's Clock. Viewers on the West Coast will see these shows at their regularly scheduled time.
Well, for those people who stayed here in the stadium, they have been rewarded. A lot left at the end of the third quarter.
Ernest Biner limping off the field. Remember now, a field goal could tie. 35 seconds left, two timeouts for the Ravens. And a charge timeout with the injury to Biner. Because there are inside the last 2 minutes, the injury is a charge timeout to Baltimore. So it cost them a timeout. They only have one left. See Jerry Markwright saying to Ted Marchibota, can't help it. That's the rule.
You're absolutely right, Tom. Good call. Good pickup. They don't want to, the NFL doesn't want that situation like they have in Canada. You know, they got the last 2 minutes, they got guys laying all over the field.
So only one timeout left for Baltimore. They have the ball at their own 27. Just for the record, Stover's longest field goal of the season is 50 yards.
Right over to the sideline talking to Ted Marchibota for a further explanation of the loss of that timeout. But Tom, you're absolutely right. What a change. First half dominated by Baltimore and Bam Morris, and Mark Brunell and McCardell took over in the second half.
Right. Boy, Brunell, what a performance. Two, we highlighted the quarterbacks to start the day, and they have both responded. Testaverde has had a big day, too. He needs it to be even bigger to try to pull out at least a tie and send it to overtime. Testaverde trying to run, and then the pass out of bounds, no good. Jermaine Lewis.
Now, Vinny is lobbying that he was forced out of bounds, but.
And a discussion here.
Jermaine Lewis.
Nope.
Oh, now they're going to give it to him.
Well, he said he was pushed out. Okay, that's the call.
With a force out.
Vinny does a good job of avoiding Clyde Simmons on the pressure. I don't know. His momentum was carrying him to the sideline. I think his momentum would have had him out of bounds, not the push.
Ball at the 43, 27 seconds. Play clock just got it away. Testaverde sacked. Lagerman, one of the Jaguars there. Don Davey is there.
Fumble. Jacksonville has the ball.
And they have indeed. As Big Clyde Simmons came out of there with a football. Now Testaverde is arguing it should not be ruled a fumble.
His argument, I think, is grasp and control.
In any event, Mark Bright says Jacksonville ball, and that will do it.
How about that? Vinny was trying to stand in there a little extra long to try to make a completion down the field. And we haven't called Clyde Simmons' name much this particular day, but that's certainly a big one.
Huge come from behind win by the Jaguars.
Bracken's 90 flushes him. Simmons gets on him. I can't tell when the ball is loose. Let's see if we can show it any better here. He's in a whole bunch of people. And Simmons is lying there on the ground with it. Before Vinny was down, he pulled it away from him. But they'll be replaying that one for a long time in Baltimore.
Huge come from behind win for Jacksonville, rivaling their upset of the Steelers.